Bills, the AFC champions, showed exactly that, but for only three quarters. In the fourth quarter, the New England Patriots of old, they had their mistakes. That hurt them very much, James.
Bill Parcells certainly did have quite a conversation with this team all week long, and New England, having won the coin toss, they've elected to receive, and on the return, fumble on the return, recovered by Detroit. Touchdown, the Lions that quickly strike. And the Lions, talk about the quick strike Lions. Willie Clay takes the fumble back in, and you know Bill Parcells, who was trying to eliminate the mistakes of the fourth quarter last week, boy, he's not too pleased with that one on the opening kickoff return. Willie Clay with a 19-yard fumble recovery for a touchdown, and the Lions that quickly on the board. Now, Wayne Fonts had mentioned to us, Dennis, that it was so important for his team to take this crowd out of it early. I don't think he realized it was going to be this quickly.
I certainly didn't think it was going to come on the first play of the football game, James. That's something that Coach Parcells does not want to happen to his football team.
And speaking of first, what a first. As Jason Hansen adds the point after, as we take a look at the replay of this fumble and the recovery by Willie Clay.
Jason Hansen's carrying the football well there. He just gets a hat right on the football. Very hard for him to hang on to that ball. Tell you, that's fantastic coverage by the Lions special team.
Bill Parcells, first year here on the sidelines for the New England Patriots after 2 years in the broadcast booth. And Dennis, in our conversation with him, he was genuinely excited about being back in the ranks of coaches.
Bill Parcells, very pleased to be back on the sidelines. When we were talking to him yesterday, he was bright-eyed, he was excited, he was bubbly. He was just fantastic to interview. We really had a good time with him. However, something like this cannot make Bill feel very good right now.
Troy Brown will get the opportunity to return this kickoff. Maybe, I should say, because last week, this young man right here, Jason Hansen, seven kickoffs, all touchbacks, one even through the uprights. And Hansen pushes Brown about 3 yards deep. He comes out. Brown across the 20 and drops at about the 26. So a successful kickoff return this time, as we take a look at number 11, Drew Bledsoe, the outstanding rookie quarterback, as I mentioned, of whom so many great things are expected. Many predict this guy could be one of the all-time greats as we look at the offensive line of the New England Patriots.
The New England offensive line here, James, they've got Bruce Armstrong. He is certainly one of the best in the game. Eugene Chung, number 69. Bill Lewis, number 75. All the way over to Pat Harlow. The receivers and backs, Leonard Russell, number 32. Fullback, Sam Gash. Vincent Brisby, wide receiver at number 82.
Leonard Russell, the lone back, on a bootleg. Bledsoe looking with time. Tosses an easy one, and Coach takes it up to about the 39. And as we take a look at the defense that the Lions will be throwing at New England.
Right in, Dan Owens, number 90. Lawrence Peete, nose tackle, number 96. Mark Spindler, left end, number 93. Right outside linebacker, Pat Swilling, certainly one of the best in the game. Inside backers, Dennis Gibson, number 98. Chris Spillman, 54. The defensive backs, 38. Kevin Scott, Benny Blades, number 36, a free safety. Strong safety, Willie White.
That was a 13-yard pass play for the first down. This is first and 10. And running hard is Leonard Russell. And Russell, who had a problem last week with two fumbles, picks up 9 yards on the carry. You know, we did chat with him yesterday about holding on to the ball, but he didn't seem to be too concerned that that would be a continuing problem.
That wasn't something that Leonard Russell was really concerned him about. He didn't want to get too much into the game worrying about fumbling. He feels that he's just going to take the football and he's going to run. Something Leonard Russell does so well. He's a big back. Arm tackles don't work against Leonard Russell. You've got to come up and put the pop on it.
Second and one. And that looks to be enough for the first down. Nice spinning move by Sam Gash, second-year running back out of Alabama. Bill Parcells, now, you were talking as you looked at the tape, comparing this offense here with the Bill Parcells offense with the Giants. Any similarities or differences?
There are some similarities, but the glaring thing to me, James, are the differences. There's less use of the tight end. There are less uses of the heavy formations that Bill Parcells likes to use to just mash the ball up in there.
First and 10, Patriots out of the throw set from the 49. Bledsoe throws it complete to Russell, and Russell dragging two Lions with him. A 6-yard pass play for the New England Patriots, who are looking very strong in this drive.
Yeah, this is something that Coach wants to get Drew Bledsoe into. He wants to get him into the rhythm of the game. Some short passes, some confidence-building type passes. Drew sits back there. He's not going to have to sit in the pocket very long. You see that Dan Owens gets very good pressure on the inside.
Powerful running by Leonard Russell. Brings up a second and 4. Russell the lone back. Two tight ends, Cook and Coates. And this is Russell. And Russell pulling straight ahead. About a yard and a half shy. We'll call it a 3-yard pickup by Leonard Russell. Just underway here. First quarter action. 11:57 left in the first period of play. And 11 seconds is all it took for the Lions to get on the scoreboard on that 15-yard fumble recovery for a touchdown by Willie Clay.
We were talking about electricity. We were talking about lightning. That's something that they certainly showed in that first possession. In fact, 11 seconds, James. Incredible.
Third and 1 out of the pro set. Russell and Gash, the backs. Bledsoe with time. Pumps. Fire strike. Complete for the first down. And boy, what an arm. As Bledsoe found Vincent Grisby, the outstanding rookie.
The crowd comes alive. Watch this. This is extremely good power by Bledsoe. Watch the arm here. Actually, Bledsoe makes a nice read and gets to a second receiver. Here's Bledsoe in the pocket. Shows good poise. Great arm strength. Looks off his first receiver, finds his second receiver. Nice throw.
A 14-yard pass play, and the Patriots are at the 28 of the Lions. McMurtry in motion. Bledsoe finds McMurtry, and McMurtry picking up very good yardage. As a matter of fact, 10 for the first down. So the Patriots looking impressive as McMurtry beat Ray Crockett.
Drew Bledsoe looking impressive. My question, where is the Lions secondary?
Now, there are some who were saying that might be the weak point of the Lions defense. That is the secondary.
That could very well be the weak point of this defense. Obviously, in the linebackers and Spillman, in that defensive line, Dan Owens, Mark Spindler, they've got very good up front guys. The secondary could be the question.
From the 17 of Detroit, first and 10. Bledsoe looking right. Goes to a second receiver. Fade pattern incomplete. And it will bring up a second and 10 from the 17.
The Lions, they bring in the safety there. They want to show blitz. They want to kind of confuse Bledsoe a little bit. That's certainly something that Wayne Font said yesterday in our meeting that they were going to try and do to the young quarterback. Here comes, right here, they're going to show blitz. He's going to come up and settle right in here. He's going to make Drew Bledsoe think he's going to come in for the blitz. So far, Bledsoe's 4 for 5 for 44 yards. Impressive for the rookie so far. First drive.
With 3 wide out, there's a flag. Probably offsides in Detroit as Bledsoe throws it complete to McMurtry again. And McMurtry, well, I tell you, he's going to love having that quarterback there, but we did mention there is a flag on the play. But
right here on the replay, Drew Bledsoe using some smarts. That's a hard count there. You see Dan Owens to jump off sides. Drew Bledsoe showing some poise here. I'm impressed.
You and a lot of other people, Dennis, are very impressed. I mean, to get the words from the mouth of Bill Parcells. And that was George Jameson, so it brings up a 3rd and 1 for the Patriots. And I was talking about Bill Parcells. I mean, he is not one to give out praise handily, but he said Bledsoe could very well be one of the all-time best.
Bill Parcells, always honest in his evaluation. He's very high on Drew Bledsoe, as well as everyone else, myself included.
Brandon Moore, an eligible receiver, tackle eligible. Bledsoe, corner of the end zone, incomplete. And the pass was intended for the tight end, Marv Cook, and we expect to see him quite a bit as Ray Crockett was there on the coverage.
Here on the replay, you watch Drew Bledsoe, a little bit of a roll to help him with the pass. That also helped keep him away from Pat Swilling from the backside, so he can drop that ball in there just a bit long. That was good coverage that time. So Scott Sisson comes on for the Patriots. He will be attempting a 26-yard field goal to put the Pats on the scoreboard. Lions lead it 7-0. And now it's a four-point ball game. So Sisson bangs home the 26-yarder. And we've got a 7-3 ball game. Lions on top. Here at Foxborough for the home opener for the New England Patriots. Pats on the scoreboard thanks to that 26-yard field goal by Scott Sisson. And the Pats trail 7-3. One of the most dangerous return men in the National Football League. If you take a look, Mel Gray to the top of your screen to the left. To the near side is Derek Moore, number 31. Across the 25 to about the 26, so it'll be first and 10 from its own 26. Rodney Peete, for the fifth consecutive year at the helm for the Lions. One out in a tough preseason battle, some wouldn't say it was tough, and there was the offensive line of the Lions.
Jack Lynn replacing Lomas Brown. There's a spot we might want to watch today. There could be some pressure there. Dave Richards, of course, over to David Lutz.
And in the backfield, only one name, Barry Sanders.
Barry Sanders. Barry Sanders, the only running back to score for the Lions.
Three wide receivers. Peete, incomplete, threw in the direction of Brett Perryman, and nearly picked off as well by Harlan Barnett. Barnett read it well as we take a look at the defense of the Patriots.
Brent Williams at the right end. In nose guard, the ever-present Tim Goad. Mike Pitts at left end.
Linebacking core.
Right outside linebacker Chris Slade into the inside left inside linebacker Vincent Brown, and of course Andre Tippett, number 50.
And a couple of familiar names from the Giants, the old Adrian White and Renee Thompson in the backfield. Second and 10 for the Lions. Peete back to pass with time. Throws it complete to Herman Moore. Moore with the first down plus about four. Herman Moore, a big target at about 6'4", good basketball player, and Wayne Font says this guy needs to get more visibility because he can do it.
He certainly wants him to get more visibility. He wants to get him the ball. Herman Moore is a big play wide receiver. Interesting enough, Wayne Fonts thinks that Herman Moore is one of the best wide receivers in the National Football League. Second, in his opinion, only to Jerry Rice.
Ooh, now that's saying something. I think Sterling Sharp in Green Bay might have something to say about that.
I think you're right.
First and 10 from the 39. 9 minutes left in the first quarter play. Barry Sanders, first carry of the game, and Sanders is swarmed. A gain of only one. For Barry Sanders will bring up a second and 9, and certainly this guy will attract attention like that all day.
Barry Sanders is going to attract a lot of attention. They're going to get the New England Patriots going to put a lot of people up front to try and slow Barry Sanders down. They're going to play hard with the corners. That's Bill Parcells' marquee type defense. Seven in the box and hard corners makes it very difficult for a running back to get upfield.
Okay, in lay language, hard on the corners, what do you mean?
Hard on the corners, that means the corners are up, they're playing hard, waiting for the run. They're anticipating the run.
Okay. Second and 9. Peete. He can run. Incomplete. Excellent coverage that time. Pass was intended for Green. We'll take it to New York and Greg Gumbel.
All right, James, and we'll take you to Green Bay, where Reggie White's already made his presence felt against his former mates, the Eagles. That's Reggie chasing down and stripping the ball from Randall Cunningham. Packers recover. Eagles drive halted in a scoreless first quarter. JB?
All right, Greg, we got a chance to see Reggie White up close last week. Excellent game, not so much from a statistical standpoint, but his teammates benefited by the coverage he was getting. Third and 9. Six defensive backs in for the Patriots. Peete under pressure. Sacked, fumbled, and recovered by Chris Slade, the University of Virginia.
There's that pressure right there that we were talking about early in the coming up. Oh, this is just great pass rush. Good job. He comes around the corner. Chris Slade shows good explosion and great awareness and stripping the ball. Watch this. He goes for the football, picks it up. He's even going to try and run with it. Great job by Chris Slade. Here he is coming off the corner. A nice finesse move. Once again, great presence, a presence of mind to strip at that football. Gives the New England Patriots excellent field position.
The rookie from the University of Virginia giving Parcells something to smile about. Bledsoe on first down. Complete in between two defenders and enough for a first down. Boy, Bledsoe has got a rocket of an arm.
He certainly does. This is an electric game. The New England Patriots, the Detroit Lions, this is exciting. Drew Bledsoe drops back his first read, makes the pass to Greg McMurtry. Great catch.
Boy, I tell you, Bledsoe can get himself out of many holes with that sharp arm. First and 10, ball at the 23 of the Lions, 7:30. Left in the first quarter play. On the draw, this is Gash. Bouncing outside, but a good bit of pursuit by that Detroit defense and a loss of two on the play as Detroit's defense comes through, led by Dennis Gibson. You know, when we talked to Bill Parcells, he said, with that Detroit defense, they seem to go from conservative to bizarre. You just don't know what's coming.
That's a wonderful thing. You like to have a defense like that, that an offensive coordinator doesn't know what's going to come at him. They go play after play after play, four-man front, three-man front. James, they'll even throw six linebackers in there in the front, and whenever the ball snapped, it looks like a fire drill.
And Hank Bulla, the master behind that one. Second and 12. Bledsoe. Russell. Inside the 20 by Leonard Russell. They need to get to about the 13 for a first down. Regain six as we take a look at Pat Swilling.
Here comes Pat Swilling against Bruce Armstrong, widely considered one of the best offensive tackles in the game. Leonard Russell is supposed to just bump on Pat Swilling and release outside. That's a good play call. Pat Swilling certainly thinks he's one-on-one with the running back. He likes that matchup, and he's coming. They just dump the ball over his head.
Mm-hmm. Vincent Brisby, you're looking at now the outstanding rookie from Northeast Louisiana. Four wides in for the Patriots. On third and six, Bledsoe from the shotgun drills it. Complete but shy, 2 yards of the first down. Now, Dennis, again, good coverage, but the receiver must run that route enough to get the first down.
The receiver's got to have the presence of mind to get past the stick to get the first down. He's got to keep turning that at an angle. He's coming back. The pass is going to be there. Ben Coach, wonderful catch. Got to get that first down. The New England Patriots fans ecstatic. Here comes Bill Parcells on fourth down.
This play worked well for them last week. It was a 54-yard touchdown pass to Ben Coates. This time it's on the keeper and the first down. Russell pulls ahead.
The fans have got to be excited. Fourth down. This is just good running. Leonard Russell just puts his head down and carries it past for the first down. Good play calling.
Take a look at the first downs. The Patriots, although trailing on the scoreboard 7-3, doing the job in the first down department. Sam Gash, Leonard Russell, the backs out of the pro set. From the 11, first and 10, this is Russell. And Russell crawling his way to about the 7 for the Patriots. You know, ticket sales, season ticket sales up 37% when Bill Parcells came to town. And thus far, it appears that the fans do have reason to be excited.
They certainly do. I tell you, the people here are excited. You can just feel it in the air. They're excited to be here. Bill Parcells has brought that enthusiasm to this football club and, in fact, to this part of the country.
Wayne Fox knew that the crowd had to be out of it right now. Not so sure. They did on the first play, but not since then. Flags on the play, stopping the play, and a little continued chin and shoving by Pat Swilling and Sam Gash. Our referee today is Gary Lane.
Bolt start, offense, number 77, prior to the snap, 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
And you may have heard me emphasize, Lane, we've got a Gary Lane in the booth, a Gary La-
Lang downstairs in the truck, and a Gary Lane on the field. It'll be second and 11 for the Patriots. Pat Harlow, the guilty party that time. Ball moved back at the 12. McMurtry in motion. Bledsoe looking right. Down to the one, and there's a flag on the play as Gash comes up with the reception. Nice job by Bledsoe, who was looking hard to the right and then came to the middle of the field. And again, we talked about seeing that in the tape, that he seemed to have a tendency to do that, and even the Lions players commented on that.
Drew Bledsoe liked to muscle that football in there. It'd be interesting to watch him. A young quarterback in the NFL doesn't want to get into that game.
And this goes against the Lions.
An interesting point. The New England Patriots are blocking Pat Swilling with Leonard Russell. That's a matchup I think as the game wears on might be to a disadvantage for the Patriots.
Oh, disadvantage?
To a disadvantage.
Why so?
Anytime you get Patrick Swilling one-on-one, especially with a running back, I think he'll outman him.
Illegal contact, number 38 is accepted. 5-yard penalty, first down.
And that is on Kevin Scott, the corner for the Lions. That was clearly it. So it'll be first and goal, ball marked at the 7. Marv Cook, Ben Coach, the two tight ends in for the pass. Russell, the lone back, and the ball carrier. And inside the 5. Now, let me go back to that again. You mentioned Swilling on Russell would work to the advantage of the Lions. Let me play Joe Fan. My goodness, Russell's a big man back there waiting to pop Swilling as he comes through.
Leonard Russell is a big man. He sits back there, but he's young, James. He is young. That's going to be something I anticipate the Lions and Pat Swilling will be quite an interesting matchup. It's a matchup that I would think Pat Swilling's to win.
All right, we'll keep an eye on that one. Second and goal from the 4. 2:55 left in the quarter. Lions on top, 7-3. On the ground again. This is Russell, and Russell dropped in the backfield. Give the credit to Chris Spielman and make that a loss of about, what, 3 or 4 on the plate. There is a guy who is football personified, Spielman.
Chris Spielman, he is intense. He knows where that ball is going to go before the ball is even snapped. He knows the formation. He knows the personnel that's in the football game. Once again, Chris Spielman comes through. He sees the guard pull. He's just nice right behind the guard. That's the guard's man to pick up that linebacker in Chris Spielman. Chris Spielman with that quickness gets him to the play.
Ball at the 7, third and goal. Bledsoe with time. Great coverage by the Lions. Bledsoe doesn't like to run, but does. And picks up or regains about 3, but he's still going to be well shy. So the field goal unit comes in for the Patriots. The education of Drew Bledsoe continues. We saw him in practice as Bill Parcells continued to yell out situations to him, seeing how well he responded. This will be a 22-yard field goal attempt by Scott Sisson. And the second field goal of the afternoon and the quarter for the Patriots brings them within 1 of the Lions, 7-6.
It tastes less filling. Can your beer do this? AT&T, we help put your world within reach. And by Levi's loose-fitting jeans, a loose interpretation of the original.
A very early autumn field here at Foxborough Stadium. And Dennis, I know you know what that's all about for the days on the sidelines.
There goes the chalkboard there. Lamar sitting there giving his defensive lineman what for. He's telling him what the problems they're having, what the New England Patriots offensive line is doing to them. I would think that's something of a pass scheme, the type of protections that the Patriots are using.
And Mel Gray taking a short kickoff return as he gets it up to about the 27-yard line. So it'll be first down for the Lions as Rodney Peete comes out. You know, in talking about Rodney Peete with Wayne Fonts, Foss really did sing his praises, saying the guy can run, he's got the arm, and he's matured, and he's going to need all of that today. They only hold a one-point lead. England trailing by 1-7-6 here late in the first quarter. And one thing I found out about Dennis Byrd is he's regained his football form. He's beating up on me up here in the box. But I tell you what, New England could easily have gotten down when Detroit struck quickly, but they're back to Parcells football.
They certainly could have. Whenever Detroit scored quickly, that's certainly something Bill Parcells doesn't want. But what Bill Parcells wants, he's got 11 minutes and 48 seconds worth of ball control. That's Bill Parcells football.
This is the Lions style of football, handed to Barry Sanders, but Sanders is being eyed and spied nicely. A gain of only one on this carry as well. You know, such a humble guy, Barry Sanders, and he knows that every form of junk defense is going to be thrown at him.
Yeah, Barry Sanders obviously knows that. He knows his position in this football team. Not only is he such a threat carrying the football, but he makes defenses play towards him, which in turn opens up the tight ends and the wide receivers.
Brett Perryman in motion, three wide. The pitch to Sanders, and Sanders, boy, excellent hustle on the part of Chris Singleton out of Arizona to get through in the backfield, and a gain again of only one. Now, again, Wayne talked about, yes, I know New England may have seven guys spying on Barry, but we still want to run it. Good game plan or not?
I think it is a good game plan. What it does is it gets those Patriots playing Barry Sanders, and the Detroit Lions are going to go for that big play strike. That's the type of football team. That's the type of offense they are. Wayne Fonts, look for him to go downfield.
The big play strike to whom, I guess, will be the answer we're looking for as we wrap up the first quarter play here in Foxborough. We've got a close ball game. Lions on top by one. As I mentioned, an early autumn look here in Foxborough. Nice looking setting there. And my goodness, talk about nice looking. I don't know if that's necessarily nice looking. What is this you're drawing, Dennis?
Well, that's Terry Bradshaw there, James. I'm just learning how to draw again. I figured I'd pick a simple subject to work with.
I'm sure he appreciates that. He'll take it as a compliment. Back to game action here. Third and seven for the Lions. Ball at their own 33 as we start the second quarter play. Peete drills it complete to Brett Perryman. Patriots are saying no, it was a scoop up, but in fact it looked to be good from here as Perryman showed an excellent pair of hands.
Perryman, a very good wide receiver, very good speed here. Rodney Peete shows good arm strength with this pass. A little bit low though. That's a hard one to call, folks. That's why we have officials on the field, James. It makes it a lot easier for them to call it than us.
Now, what is too close to call is whether or not it's a first down.
Right.
Maybe by the width of an ant's ankle.
That's an interesting example.
That's
here,
pretty
James.
Close.
that's pretty close.
Oh, gosh.
I can't believe they're paying me to do this, James.
Well, partner, I'm having a blast with you, let me tell you. And I'm going to get in shape to contend with you. You're looking awfully good, not only walking, but moving around and hitting strong up here. So it'll be fourth and inches, and it looks like the Lions have decided to go for it. Wayne Fox getting creative. Risk taker from his own 40. Fourth and inches. What do you think?
I don't know. I don't think he got it. It just depends on the spot. What a surge defensively for the Patriots.
Now, that's interesting to hear you say, because if you were watching tape again, last week the Patriots were being blown off the ball.
Last week against that Buffalo offensive line, the New England Patriots just could not handle themselves, and they have stopped the Detroit Lions.
We'll see. They're going to measure it, and we'll find out how good or how close the spot. And it would look like the ant's knee got a little slimmer, and they did get it.
Oh.
We'll see. But that stick, that chain has been through some wars, has it not?
Certainly looks like it has.
Well, Dennis, your eyes are better, as we'll chalk one up for you.
How dare you challenge me, Jim?
Well, the eyes. eyes of Dennis Byrd confirm that the defense of the Patriots did the job. American League East, Baltimore a game and a half back, New York a game and back of Toronto. As we take a look also in the National League West, Atlanta now in first place, have been trailing by around 10 games to San Francisco at the All-Star break. And of course, CBS Sports will keep you right on top of all the pennant races. The Red Sox still very much in it as they take on the Yankees or the Mets against the Braves. That'll be coming your way next Saturday, 2:30 Eastern time, right here on CBS. And Drew Bledsoe talking things over in the huddle. And I tell you, you talk about confidence building in that first quarter. Parcells really did go to his strengths.
Yes, he certainly did. Leonard Russell dipping to the outside for 2 yards.
That's a strength, Leonard Russell.
That is definitely a strength. And Leonard Russell, speaking of strength, very strong running back. A lot of power there. Unusual speed for a big man of Leonard Russell's size.
A gain of 3 on that play will bring up a 2nd and 7. He was stopped by Dennis Gibson. You know, you were talking yesterday in enthusiastic terms about, speaking of defense, and Chris Spielman. I mean, this guy really is. He comes to play football, and he's doing that already in the first quarter.
Yeah, I think Chris Spielman has the playbook. He's already got 7 tackles today.
Wow, with 13:45 left in the half. Incomplete pass intended for Marv Cook, just beyond his outstretched hands. You know, as we look at Marv Cook, and I think about, again, the Bill Parcells teams of old, Parcells is so accustomed to having bigger, stronger tight end types.
Bill Parcells likes to have the tight ends that can block well, that can move people out of there. In Marv Cook, you've got more of a finesse style of tight end. Coates, he's a little bit the same way. I think Coates will be able to be a little bit better blocker than Marv Cook will. Coates, certainly a lot of talent there at tight end. A lot of talent overall.
From the 38 of Detroit, 3rd and 7. Out of the shotgun. Incomplete. Picked off. It was tipped up. And Ryan McNeil has it for the Lions. Dragged down at about the 45-yard line. And a flag on the play at the end of that run. And Detroit comes up with another turnover. And again, that was the essence of the conversation that Bill Parcells had with his team all week, protecting the ball.
Protect that football. That's a pet peeve for Coach Bill Parcells. Do not turn the football over. Bill Parcells is known for mistake-free football. McNeil showing that he can do a little bit with the ball after he catches it there, James.
And most players out of Miami know what to do with the football.
On the return team, number 59, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Well, you heard it. That was on a young man that you know all too well, Tracy Scroggins, as Wayne Fonts looks on. Pleased, though, with what he's seeing as the guys are forcing turnovers.
Receiver here coming, doing a little bit of an in route. The defensive back, a little bit early, I thought. That I originally had thought that could possibly have been the penalty. The wide receiver is actually the one that tips the ball, and McNeil just comes up with it. Nice heads-up play. He goes up for the ball at its highest point, comes down with it. That is good football.
And that drill right there is one that is a constant in practice for the DBs, the tip drill. Bledsoe looking strong, confidence-building numbers there. New England has done the job time of possession, as Dennis Byrd said, Bill Parcells type of football, and clearly doing the job in terms of total yards. But the reason the score is 7-6, Detroit capitalizing on turnovers, striking 11 seconds into the game, and they come up with a turnover here. 1st and 10 for the Lions from their own 32. Sanders. And boy, Sanders is not being given any room to run, a gain of only 2. And for the man whom his college coach said could run through a keyhole, he doesn't have that much room right now.
Just a little bit less than a keyhole here. It's a good example of the hard corner coming up. Watch the corner come in, turn Barry Sanders into the inside. Barry doesn't get to go all the way to the outside like he'd like to. There's the cornerback, turns the ball in. All of that help in there. That's what you want a cornerback to do. Turn that ball in there to the defenders that are playing from inside out.
On 2nd and 8, Herman Moore to the near side. Peete back to pass. drills it complete to Moore, and Moore has the first down. Now, we talked earlier about a receiver running a route enough to get that first down. That was an example of it.
That was a very good example of Herman Moore knowing where the chains are, knowing where the first down is, catching the football, protecting it in enough to get the first down.
Parcells' old team leading by seven, and Morton Anderson, he of the golden foot, has broken the consecutive game with field goal record. That guy deserves the money he gets, especially with the style of football they play in New Orleans. 12:27 left in the half to play. Peete drills it complete. Nice catch by Brett Perryman. And speaking of the Saints, the ex-Saint. A tip drill there as he brings it in, a 17-yard pass play.
Brett Perryman being a little bit exciting play here. He goes up, tips the ball himself, much like the interception a play ago. This time, Brett Perryman comes down with the football. Rodney under a little bit of pressure there.
And I tell you, one of the reasons Perryman might have been a little upset is he saw Andre Tippett coming his way, the black belt martial arts practitioner.
I guarantee it'd make you think twice about sticking your arms up high like that.
First and 10 from the 39 of the Patriots to Sanders. And Sanders still not given any daylight as the Patriots swarm him. Now, it's interesting. Bill Parcells thus far has the right defensive scheme to stop Sanders. I asked him in the two previous times he's met Sanders, he's limited him to less than 60 yards both games. And he said, hey, I had a much different crew. Don't expect it from this crew.
Yep, Bill Parcells. He was talking about that different crew that he had. Lawrence Taylor, Wilbur Marshall, Carl Banks. He said these are guys that nobody could block. Not just you'd get one guy unblocked, but you'd have three guys unblocked the entire play.
Sanders on five carries, only 6 yards. Second and 10. Peete picked off. And the Patriots, Darryl Wren, comes up with the interception.
Darryl Wren, the third teamer, comes up with the interception. The wide receiver just slips. Darryl Wren there. A very opportunistic catch for Darryl.
11 minutes left in the half to play. Detroit on top by one. You say the fans of New England really ought to be excited about this team.
They should be very excited. They're playing very good defense. They're swarming to the football. Offensively, they're doing a fantastic job. Drew Bledsoe, 74 yards so far.
And that one wasn't held very well. Now, again, and somebody tuning in may say, well, gosh, Dennis, the score is only 7-6, Detroit on top. How in the world can you say there ought to be excitement about the Patriots?
They're playing very good football, James. They're playing mistake-free football right now. The one interception that Drew Bledsoe did throw, that was a tipped football. That's not Drew's fault. Drew Bledsoe, the reason to be excited, he's playing very good. He's playing much like a veteran would be playing today.
He certainly has one of the best veteran coaches to work with in Bill Parcells and Ray Perkins, who spends most of the time with Bledsoe in the education process. Little swing pass. And Russell still
wow.
on his feet. Now, there is an example of that power we were talking about that Leonard Russell possesses. 8 yards picked up on a play will bring up a third and two.
Leonard Russell, everybody talks about the running backs going out of bounds these days. Leonard Russell is not going to be tonight. He doesn't want to go out of bounds. Watch this. Dodges the first, takes the hit, and drives. Look at that leg. They're just churning. They're driving. Just going to get that first down. He's working hard.
You know who would appreciate that running style? My namesake,
Mr. James Brown.
Yes, indeed. Jim Brown talks about guys taking the punishment and delivering it. On third down, here's Russell again. And he's going to be shy. About a yard and a half of the first down marker. Benny Blades in on the tackle for the Lions. 10-12 left in the second quarter of play. 7-6 ball game. Lions on top as you take a look at Armstrong and Harlow. And again, Baldinger, who got the starting nod in place of Todd Rucci, but you think that Rucci's going to be a good one.
Rucci's a very good football player. He's just young right now. That's why Rich Baldinger is in there. He's got the experience, and he's going to help the young kid along.
Mike Saxon on the punt for the Patriots. And signaling for the fair catch was Mel Gray. It takes a New England bounce and heads out of bounds about the 14-yard line. So Mike Saxon comes through with a 48-yard punt. And the Lions will start at their own 14.
look at this graphic, certainly this could fall under the category of did you know Wayne Fonts, believe it or not, fourth longest tenure with the same team of coaches in the league. All, of course, behind one Don Shula. Play action. Peete. Complete. And for the first down, as Marty Thompson continues to pick up another yard or two, heading up near the 30.
Once again, James, that's where Coach Fonts was talking about getting the football to the tight ends. Whenever Barry Sander is not getting the yards that he needs to around the corner or up the middle, they're going to get the ball to the tight ends.
You know, as we take a look at this score here, Phoenix leading Washington 10-0. Mark Rippon, who had started off so well, was in camp looking sharp, and he's out with ligament damage. So Rich Gannon, recently acquired from the Minnesota Vikings, will get the play. Boy, nice improvisation on a part of Rodney Peete. Lost the handle on the ball, picked it up and still threw, and completed it to Brett Perryman. Now, is that good for the first down? There is a spot. It is, in fact, the first down. Boy, talk about a good play. It wasn't in the book, though, for sure. It wasn't drawn up that way.
No, it certainly wasn't drawn up that way. That's just a good heads-y play by Rodney Peete. He doesn't lose his composure. He just bends down, pick up the football, and fires it to the wide receiver.
8:30, left and a half. Lions on top, 7-6, first and 10 from the 40. And Sanders barely got that handoff. And talk about being in the backfield on the play. Was that Andre Tippett?
That was Andre Tippett. I guarantee you Andre Tippett would like to know who was going to get the ball that time.
It was almost given to him. The NFL on CBS continues next Sunday with a strong lineup of games. Barry Sanders and these same Lions at New Orleans, Washington at Philadelphia, Rams at the Giants. And then at 4 o'clock, it'll be Atlanta at San Francisco. And, of course, it all gets started with the NFL today. Second and 7. Sanders has a hold. And Sanders runs for the first down, a pickup of about 13 yards on a play by Barry Sanders. And you know that you just can't stop him every time.
That's what Coach Fonts wants to get into. Obviously, in the beginning of the game, you've got to try and establish your running game. What he's done, he's loosened up the New England Patriots defense with some passes to the tight end. He's got them a little bit more honest on their coverages. That gives Barry Sanders just that keyhole that we were talking about earlier, just to run.
First and 10 for the Lions. Ball at the 48 of New England, 7:05, left and a half to play. To Sanders again. Sanders juking. Forward motion and progress will have him at about the 45. Linebacker Vincent Brown in on the tackle for New England. Houston on top of Philadelphia. Things a little closer there as well. As a matter of fact, Philadelphia at one point had a commanding lead. A lot of eyes will be on that ball game there. Second and 8 from the 45. Peete decides to run it and dives. The ball should be marked at the 40. That'll be a pickup of 5. Now, if this guy, Rodney Peete, can stay healthy, I know he's had some problems staying healthy the past few years, but Wayne Fonts feels he's got all the proper ingredients for this Lions ball club to be extremely good.
Rodney Peete, extremely good leader. Coming into the season, they weren't real sure who was going to start for the football team. Andre Ware, got Rodney Peete. I think Rodney's showing just a little bit more of the leadership qualities that Wayne Fonts wanted.
Third and 3. 3 wideouts in. Holman in motion. And Peete runs for the first down and gives himself up at the 35. So a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll be a first down for the Lions with 5:23 left in the half.
Speaking of Rodney Peete and injuries in the past, this is the play that Rodney Peete, he's not going to allow himself to get hit. He's going to get upfield, get the first down, improvisational type play, take the hook slide.
Mm-hmm. And that's a smart move.
That's a very smart move, James.
You know, the guy is such a competitor, and I know in a lot of quarterbacks who have that running ability, one of the habits you have to break is that desire to want to just go ahead and be
mano a mano. That competitive atmosphere around Rodney Peete, he wants to carry that football. He wants to get that first down. He realizes now he's got to take it to the ground.
Play action. Complete to Sanders. Sanders fumbles. And fumbles it out of bounds at about the 33. Picked up a couple more yards. I tell you, with this guy, everything is still advancing forward, huh?
Vincent Brown comes up, makes it, wraps up nicely. He pops the ball out with a forearm shot right there. He doesn't go for the juke, but Barry picks up the ball, keeps his head about him. If he can't keep it in front of him, he'll just get it out of bounds.
And, of course, because he didn't have possession of the ball, so the ball is going to be spotted at the 35, which is the spot of the fumble. 4:35, left and a half, 7-6 ball game, Detroit on top. Second and 9 for the Lions. Coming more to the near side. Peete, under pressure, escapes and gets smashed from behind, but looks to have the first down if you look at the near side chains. Mike Pitts finally wrapped him up and smashed him to the ground. And it is a first down for Rodney Peete. You know, it's clear that so many teams, Dennis, also are trying to get that 49er style of attack and having the resources of the running back, a good pass-catching tight end, and a quarterback who can run as well.
Yeah, Dan Hennings comes into this offense. Wayne Fonts wanted to utilize a tight end more. Dan Hennings brings that to this offense. They don't want to be known as a run and shoot. They want to be known as a one-back offense.
Mm-hmm. Miscue on a play, but Detroit comes up with it. That's the second time it's happened, but Barry Sanders alertly falls on the ball.
Detroit beginning to look a little bit sloppy here. Rodney Peete does not, he pivots the wrong way. Rodney should have reversed out the other direction. He would not have ran into his offensive guard that way. That's a busted play by Rodney Peete.
Now, again, in terms of timing, because that was David Lutz who actually ran into him, but you're saying the fault that time is on Peete and not Lutz?
Well, you know those offensive linemen, they've just got to get out there. It's the quarterback's responsibility to take the snap and get out of their way. They need to block for the running back.
Second and 14. Peete, nowhere to run or hide as he's wrapped up. Three Patriots, Slade, Tippett, and Jones.
This is a designed quarterback draw. Rodney Peete steps back and begins to look. There's nowhere for him to go at this point. All blue jerseys. Nice looking jerseys indeed. All new. First time the New England Patriots have ever worn blue.
Mm-hmm. And there's that new logo. I guess it has that modernistic theme to it. Boy, makes it look faster. But with that guy right there, Andre Tippett, he doesn't need to be so fast. He's mean. And a timeout called on the field. And we've got a break in the action. The timeout charged to the Lions. They've got two remaining, but lead by one. Congratulations to Steffi Graf, who continues to roll on the women's side. Congratulations on her championship yesterday. Third and 14 for the Lions. Ball at the 30 of New England. Play action. Peete on the run. Incomplete. Flag on a play. The intended receiver was Willie Green. We were looking at Maurice Hurst there, and Dennis, you can tell he obviously is upset. He thought he was right there in plenty of time. As Gary Lane sorts it out with the housekeeping with his crew.
Maybe a bit early, James.
Mm-hmm. Say just a bit, huh?
Just a bit.
Now, you know, I know we see these conferences take place in players. Have you ever seen or been involved in a situation where you've convinced the officiating crew differently?
I've certainly given it my best shot, I know that. You know, sometimes you get in there, and you get excited, you get into one of the officials, and you just start pleading your case. Sometimes you can help.
Double foul. Illegal contact, number 27. Defensive pass interference, number 37. Ineligible receiver, number 70, downfield. Penalties offset. We play third down.
Wow. I guess he said it best.
I guess so. I don't think anybody could have argued their case in that one, James.
Talk about nullify him.
Holy smokes.
Well, the net effect is it'll be third and 14. Bill Parcells is talking to his crew upstairs, trying to sort through it as well.
2:32 left in the half. Patriots trailing by one, 7-6. Ball at the 30 of New England. Peete back to pass. Oh, now he's dropped. Chris Slade having himself one outstanding afternoon. Second sack of the afternoon for the rookie from Virginia.
Well, here comes Chris Slade once again on the young guy. Oh, that's what I thought was going to happen in this game. Jack Lynn letting the inside go. He opened the gate. Chris Slade more than happy to take the inside move for the quarterback sack.
Jim Arnold on to punt for the Lions from midfield. And taken at the 8, Troy Brown. And Brown run out of bounds at about the 21. And there's a flag on the field, unsportsmanlike conduct still. 29-yard punt, a 12-yard return by Brown. And it goes against the Lions. We'll see who the culprit is.
Personal foul. Number 32 on the kicking team. Unnecessary roughness. Hands to the face. 15 yards. First down.
That was called on Willie Clay. And Wayne Fox not screaming too much about it because he knows he was right there and saw it.
Say about your artwork.
I only imagine he will have something to say.
The question is, what?
No, the question is when.
Oh, he'll get it in.
Oh, I know.
On first and 10, Bledsoe complete to the 40. And wrapping up and holding on to it was Marv Cook. A 5-yard gain on the play will be a second and 5. A hurry up offense. Detroit with 2 timeouts remaining. The Pats with 3. Incomplete. Complete for a second, then dropped as Timpson, Michael Timpson, had it for a second, and believe it or not, those are the kind of catches you should hold on to.
Yeah, those are certainly catches that you need to make, especially inside the 2-minute warning before the half. This is an interesting position on the field for Drew Bledsoe. It will be interesting to watch how he does under this kind of pressure when things are picked up. He doesn't have the time to sit in there relaxed. He's got to think quickly. It'll be interesting to watch how well Drew performs. So far, he's done a good job.
That he has. Wow, Washington trailing Phoenix 17-0. Now, certainly one of the head coaches going into this season having to do the job is Joe Bugel, the head coach of the Phoenix Cardinals. Management said, hey, we've given you the resources. We went out active on the free agent market. You got Garrison Hurst now produced, so his job is on the line, and that would be a very big win for him to knock off the Redskins.
That would be a great win for him. Unfortunately for Rippon, the torn ligaments in his knee. What Joe Bugel needs to do is to pull off a victory here. That would set him in good stead with the Phoenix organization.
Mm-hmm. So we take a look at Bill Parcells. And, yeah, you know what? This team has almost undergone nearly 50% change. 27 different faces and names on the roster. Nearly 13, depending upon what look he wants to give you, a new starter. So he's got his kind of a squad out there.
Yeah, Bill Parcells does. What Bill Parcells, he's going towards that youth movement right now. He likes those personalities. What he wants to do is take these young guys and develop them into mature veteran football players.
He'll be the first to tell you, though, the talent level is not where he wants to be yet. On 3rd and 5, Bledsoe incomplete as he drilled it in there. That pass was right there. I tell you, this is one guy who could certainly thread the needle, if you will.
This is great to watch. Pat Swilling and Bruce Armstrong, two of the best in the league. Watch Bruce Armstrong. Gets that inside hand in there, posts up Pat Swilling, and just holds him out. Good job by Bruce Armstrong.
And that's exactly why a number of the Patriots were saying we're not too worried about Swills because we have Armstrong over there.
They've got their other big guy, the Patriots do. Bruce Armstrong, fantastic offensive lineman.
Mike Saxon with his second punt of the afternoon for the Patriots. And Mel Gray pushed back, and he decides to let it go for a touchback, but there is a flag on a play at about the near side 23.
a 60-yard punt by Saxon, but there is a flag. Talking once again about Bruce Armstrong, there's an offensive lineman, had a knee injury last November. People said that he was going to miss this entire football season, James.
Mm-hmm.
He wasn't going to have any of it. He sat down, began to rehab that knee. He's playing again today. He says the only thing he has a little bit now is just a little bit of stiffness, not much. He's impressed that he doesn't feel worse than he does.
Well, you talk about a serious work ethic and rehabbing. Bruce Armstrong certainly displayed that. In
illegal hands in the face, defense number 38, prior to the kick, 5 yards penalty, first down.
Well, you heard that call. And Dennis, just to finish the point about Bruce Armstrong in the rehab, something that Bill Parcells was very pleased about, Armstrong was quite pleased hearing the words of compliment coming from you, the words of compliments coming from you, knowing about the kind of effort you put into rehab.
You know, that's something that athletes are accustomed to, that hard work, that dedication, that devotion. Bruce Armstrong just showed that he's got what it takes inside his heart. Not only the physical attributes does he have, but he's got it inside as well.
1:24 left in the half. Patriots trailing 7-6. Have the ball back at their own 45. First and 10. Four wideouts. Bledsoe out of the shotgun. Incomplete. Intended receiver Michael Timpson. Dennis, interestingly, I mentioned to you during the break how the action has kind of settled down and it's a little tug of war going on right now. You said not unexpected.
No, certainly not. First quarter, you expect everybody to be just really fired, really pumped up. Second quarter, you're settling into a rhythm of the offense and the defense. That's why things have just eased up just a little bit. Little rhythm here.
Second and 10. Bledsoe with time. Goes deep. Oh, off the fingertips of Cook. And Crockett was right there. Boy, talk about nice touch on that pass by Bledsoe.
Nice touch. Watch Drew Bledsoe. He rolls out to his left under the pressure. He's going to his left, throws with his right arm. That's tremendous arm strength. Looky there. Wow. Marv Cook would like to have this ball back again. This could have been the big play that would have put the Patriots back on top.
That was right there. Right there.
Oh, what
10
a throw.
Of 19 for 87 yards by that young man, Bledsoe. One pick thrown. On third and 10, Patriots only one of seven third down conversions. 1:14 left in the half. And Bledsoe gets it away quickly for the first down pass as Dennis Gibson was right on top of him, but he found Greg McMurtry. 14-yard pass play.
14-yard pass, that's what they needed. They needed to get the first down and get out of bounds to stop that clock. There it is, great catch, out of bounds. They got time to set up. Drew Bledsoe's got time to think about, to get in the next play, and to relax.
Speaking of time, 1:10 left in the quarter. Patriots trying to get on the scoreboard, trailing 7-6. The handoff to Turner. And Turner runs for the first down. Kevin Turner, second-year running back out of Alabama, who was a leading tackle on special teams last year.
Bill Parcells, great play selection here. He's got him thinking pass. He's got him reeling. Takes for the draw. Turner turns it upfield, gets the first down. Good play calling, James.
Now, might that have caught you by surprise if you were out there on the field?
Yeah, certainly would have, because at this point on the field, you're expecting them to hit the out routes, to hit the quick routes. To hand that ball off, you've got the linebackers playing back, playing the slant route. You hand the ball off, hope to get to the out-of-bounds stop the clock.
First and 10 from the 30, complete. Bledsoe working it to perfection. Good clock management. The clock continues to run right now, less than 55 seconds in the half. A pickup of 8 yards on a play will bring up a second and 2. Bledsoe with time. Incomplete. Intended receiver was Vincent Brisby. 40 seconds remaining in the half.
An excellent situation for Drew Bledsoe to learn about the game of football, to learn about getting in there, settling down, get into the pace, run the plays Coach Parcells sends in. Once again, excellent play calling by Coach Parcells. get the ball to the wide receivers going outside. You don't want to throw the ball down the middle unless you hit your tight end for the big strike. You don't want to let it eat up the clock that way. Going to hit the out routes, run a draw in here, get to the ball quickly, try and stop the clock.
We'll see what the call is here. Out of the pro set, but Leonard Russell calls a timeout. Second one burned off by the Patriots, leaving them with one with 40 seconds left. And I guess Parcells is thinking, hey, fellas, you should have known what the play was.
Hey, that's okay at this point. What Parcells doesn't want happening is to run the wrong play or run a play into a strong defense. Good keeping the head there, calling the timeout, not getting yourself into trouble. Hey, you've got 40 seconds left. I think he did a good job. That was a good call.
As we take a look at Bledsoe again, one of the things that Bill Parcells likes about the kid is that he's got the mindset to be able to handle a lot of learning and Parcells' brand of yelling and screaming.
You know what Bill Parcells says about this kid? He's not thin-skinned, which means he can take the heat. He's got big shoulders, you know, he can kind of shoulder the load. Drew Bledsoe is an extremely talented young man. As well as upstairs, he's got a good mind for the game of football. He's not going to let a little bit of blistering get to him inside. He's just going to take it. He's going to learn from it and be a better quarterback for it.
Detroit was hoping to try to confuse the youngster. Chris Spielman spoke as much. Has he looked confused to you?
No, he has not looked confused. Detroit hasn't been blitzing as much as I would have expected him to against the young quarterback.
Third and two from the 22 out of the pro set. Russell. And Russell bullying his way for the first down. Leonard Russell pounding his way forward, those legs turning. And the clock is still running. Benny Blades getting into it with Bill Lewis.
More than willing to give up the first play there, James, to stop the clock once again. Take the snap, ditch the ball into the ground, stops the clock, reorganize, call a play.
With exactly 23 seconds remaining.
Plenty of time to score, James.
From the 19 of the Lions. Second and 10. Russell in motion. And Detroit going offside. Flags on the play. We'll find out. It looked as if Robert Porche was the first to move, an outstanding defensive lineman prospect.
Defense, number 59, 5 yards penalty, still second down.
And it was actually on your man, Tracy Scroggins.
Tracy Scroggins. Tell you what, impressed with Drew Bledsoe. He's using the hard count. Watch him. Nice hard count. That draws that defensive front offside. At this part of the field, that's excellent. You would like to have that. Draw them offside. Take that 5 yards. Moves you downfield.
I say your man because Scroggins went to Tulsa University. Second and five. Bledsoe. Caught, but out of the end zone. What a great catch, though, by McMurtry. And again, we talk about Bledsoe. And again, I mean, what else can you do but sing this guy's praises? Take a look at what he does.
Tell you, I'm very impressed what Drew Bledsoe does. He looks off his first receiver, goes for a second. A bit high, but that's okay. Drew's going to connect on a lot of those in his career.
And a few of these guys will be working on some toe raises to jump a little higher, too. Ray Crockett, the DB on that play. Third and five, 19 seconds left. New England hoping for the touchdown, trailing 7-6. Incomplete, intended for McMurtry with 15 seconds remaining. But we'll bring up a fourth down, so the field goal crew is on. And Sisson hoping to boot the Pats into the lead.
Give the Lions defense credit there, James. They held themselves well inside the 20. That's where you want a defense to really bow up, to really play strong. Conversely, an offense, you get inside the 20, you've got to get to 7. The 3 is okay, but you need that 7 points. It could show later in the game.
This will be a 32-yarder. You saw the distances in the previous two. And Sisson gives the Patriots the lead. 9-7 New England with 11 seconds left and a half. Scott Sisson doing the job, nicely so, and you know he's got favor on the sidelines, but we hear so often about how Bill Parcells would like to play this kind of ugly football, if you will. He doesn't mind.
No, he doesn't mind. This is the kind of football Bill Parcells doesn't mind. Take up a lot of time, eat up that clock, play mistake-free football. They're doing well right now. Drew Bledsoe is playing mistake-free. Drew Bledsoe's been very impressive so far.
Let's talk a little bit about Detroit. You were mentioning how they defensively were hoping to confuse Bledsoe. Why hasn't it happened?
Well, James, what we expected the Detroit defense to blitz more than they have at this point. They haven't given as many fronts as they had shown in the last game against Atlanta, against a more experienced quarterback. I'm surprised that they haven't. I don't feel that Drew Bledsoe can pick up the blitzes. I would look for a little bit more of that in the second half.
I was about to ask, knowing Hank Bullitt, do you think maybe they're waiting to really spring the barrage in the second half?
Could very well be, James.
All right, now in the first half with 11 seconds remaining, it's a 9-7 Patriots lead. Three field goals on the foot of Scott Sisson. We take a look at Mel Gray. Still the most dangerous. From 2 yards deep. Gray slipping and sliding and getting his way up to about the 19. So a very good job of coverage on the part of the Patriots.
Good
with 6 seconds remaining. Go ahead, Dennis.
You know, a wonderful thing that Mel Gray does, and he always has, he attacks that front coming at him. He gets up. He doesn't wait. He doesn't sit there and dance around. He attacks that return. Does a very good job. Widely considered as the best in the game.
I've talked so often about the martial arts and all. Here is a guy who consistently goes in, if you will, to use the analogy, sparring sessions, because he's back there where everybody wants their head, and he's consistently the best.
He's covering for himself.
To say the least.
Yeah.
And that'll do it for the first half of play here at Foxborough Stadium. And the sellout crowd on hand shows its appreciation. That's the end of the first half with the score. The New England Patriots 9, the Detroit Lions 7. Greg and Terry will be coming up with the NFL Today halftime show after this. Downtown Boston and Providence, 28 miles from downtown Boston, 25 miles from Providence. Right now, the most important numbers in New England on top of Detroit, 9-7. Mel Gray back deep. At any time, this guy is certainly a threat to break it and go all the way. Scott Sisson will be doing the kicking. And the second half is underway. Mel Gray will take it from the 9. And Mel Gray still on his feet. Mel Gray, the dangerous one, up near the 45-yard line for the Lions. Well, as we said, this is a guy who has perfected the craft. Consistently the most dangerous return man in the NFL.
As I mentioned earlier, James, this is what Mel Gray does. This is his marquee play. He just hits the hole. He doesn't wait. He doesn't dance around and worry about getting hit, because he knows if he hits those holes that the men are blocking for him and that the guys are making for him, he'll get up there and he's not going to take any big shots.
And I'll tell you what, the offense has to feel good about making the big shot happen here. Excellent field position. First and 10 from its own 45. The pitch to Sanders to the left. Sanders still on his feet and run out of bounds at about the 47. Barry Sanders picking up 8 on that carry will bring up a 2nd and 2, knocked out by Adrian White.
Watch the line play here. It's a good surge. They get to the corner at number 82, blocks for Barry Sanders. He seals that corner off. Barry gets around the corner. Nice, powerful running there by Barry Sanders, just short of the first down.
Excellent point again. We're talking about Lomas Brown being out with that ankle injury. Thus far, it doesn't look as if Detroit is missing too much or what?
Well, of course, they've given up the sack to Slade right there off of Jack Lynn. But otherwise, Lynn's playing a good football game.
And complete for the first down. So, in fact, Lomas has been missed to some degree.
Well, certainly to Rodney Peete.
Most importantly.
Most importantly.
That pass completed for the first down from Peete to Moore. Rodney with a very intense look on his face there. Here's a guy who came into the league with an awful lot to prove, feeling that maybe he should have been taken a lot higher, but he has really grown and matured nicely in the job.
Rodney Peete's an exceptional quarterback. He shows that leadership quality that he displayed in college.
From the 41, Sanders, one of his patented moves. This guy can make a one-yard run. That's awfully exciting, and I don't even know if he got that one, so he made maybe a no-gainer. Looked awfully good. No gain on the play as he was dragged out of bounds by Harlan Barnett.
Wayne Fonts told us yesterday that he's seen Barry make some of the most beautiful three-yard runs you've ever seen anybody make.
You know, as a matter of fact, talking to the linemen, it's really great to hear them express oohs and ahs when they watch it.
You know what? We were talking to Kevin Glover once again yesterday, and what he told us is in the beginning, when they first got Barry Sanders there, they would make their blocks, and they began watching Barry. He said they were admiring his work, and Barry came back to him and said, hey, guys, get downfield. Get some blocks for me.
Keep moving. Second and 10 from the 41. This is Sanders. And I tell you, New England really making it tough on Barry Sanders to find any kind of a hole.
Two running plays for Barry Sanders. He hasn't been tackled yet. That's interesting. He's been run out of bounds.
Gain of 3 on the play. We'll bring up a 3rd and about 7.
Something that Barry Sanders provides out of that backfield, he can stop on a dime and give you change. He just hits his brakes, goes the other way, changes his field of direction, makes it very difficult for a defense to pursue the guy.
6 defensive backs in for the Patriots. Herman Moore to the top of the screen. 3rd and 7 for the Lions. Deep. Complete. Shy of the first down. Jeff Campbell fell down about a yard or two shy of the first down marker.
The ball just in front of Campbell a little bit. He would like to have got that just a little bit higher so he could turn up and make the first down. Rodney Peete putting it a little bit low. Peete feels like he should have got that ball up as well. He knows that he needed to get that first down. Very important for him. They'd like to get that 7 instead of having to settle for 3 points if, in fact, they connect.
This will be a 52-yarder by Jason Hansen, 2 of 5 career-wise from this distance. It's long enough, but no good. Well, the supreme confidence being expressed by Wayne Fonts toward Hansen, but he comes up short and is still 9-7. James Brown along with Dennis Byrd here at Foxborough Stadium. Sellout crowd on hand watching the Patriots, who hold to a 2-point lead over the Lions. 11:48 left in the 3rd. And, you know, I wish the audience at home could be a part of what we discuss and do. In between breaks, did you think I was that fast?
James, I had no clue that you'd be back that fast. I thought I was on my own.
Oh, Party, you're doing it quite nicely indeed. Russell. And Russell strung out nicely, no gain on that first down play. Will bring up a 2nd and 10.
Leonard Russell talking a little bit on Barry Sanders. Leonard Russell there wanted to show a little bit of the shake and bake that Barry Sanders got. Incidentally, yesterday when we were visiting with Leonard Russell, he said, you know what? Playing against Barry Sanders, a defensive guy, one guy ain't got a chance. Two guys, it ain't much better.
So that's why they've been sending 3 and 4 at him.
I guess so.
And they credit Russell with a yard gain, so this is 2nd and 9. Ball thrown behind the receiver, Gash. So Gash only picks up 1 as a result. Will bring up a 3rd and 8 for the Patriots. Ball marked at their own 35. And talk about a good job being done by a number of rookies from last week.
Yes, Drew Bledsoe leading all the rookies last week in his effort against the Buffalo Bills. 14 for 30 for 148 yards, 2 touchdowns, and 1 interception. Myra from Seattle, 20 attempts, 154 yards, and 1 interception for Rick Myra.
3rd and 8 for the Patriots. Bledsoe with time, throws it complete, but it's going to be short of the first down by about 4 yards. Ben Coach hauls it in. You know, Ben Coach is a guy that Bill Parcells says will see a lot of action in this offensive scheme of things. And clearly, Parcells wants to bring a lot more talent in here, but you get the impression that Coach is going to be around for a while.
You know, Bill Parcells is very high on Ben Coates. Bill Parcells, obviously an excellent judge of talent. Whenever he says something like that, of that nature about Ben Coates, you get the perception that Ben Coates is going to be around for a while, James.
Mike Saxon hoping to be around a while himself, on for the punt.
Mike Saxon, the all-time punt leader for the Dallas Cowboys.
Mel Gray signaling for the fair catch at the last second, so it'll be down at the 14, a 47-yard punt. Excellent hang time of 4.4. And the Lions will have it first and 10 from their own 14. Who won the women's title, singles title yesterday. First and 10 for the Lions. Play action. Peete throws it complete. Holman for the first down and a lot more. Rodney Holman across the 40. Finally, game tackle at about the 42. Now, you were saying that you expected to see Holman involved a lot more today.
I expect to see Holman involved. He's the tight end that they want to get the football to. He does a very good job. He's got excellent hands. He does very good after he catches it, getting that extra yardage that we've just seen from him here. Actually, even showing a little bit of tackles, Peete. That's just a great job by Chris Slade. Here we go. We got Chris Clay. Watch him come through. He's one-on-one with the running back. Comes in. Nice inside move. Too bad we don't get to see it. Wonderful job. There we go with the quarterback sack for Chris Clay. Wonderful afternoon from the young man.
Second and 18 for the Lions. And complete to the sidelines as Jeff Campbell is whacked out of bounds by Darryl Wren. Chris Slade was a multi-sport star in high school in the state of Virginia, and many thought that he was going to go on and play a little basketball, but he likes the rough stuff, and boy, is he playing well today.
He certainly showed that inside move driving the lane there to get the quarterback sacked, James.
6 yards regained on the play. Brings up a third and 12. Ball at the 41 of Detroit. Holman in motion. And Sanders somehow escapes and runs for the first down and a lot more. Barry Sanders.
Oh, man.
Dennis, once again, it looked like New England had the play perfectly diagnosed. Sanders somehow escapes.
That's vintage Barry Sanders there, James. He just plugs away, and then boom, he just goes for the big game. Watch this down here on the sidelines. This is such a fantastic move. He stopped on one leg. Look at that. Just continues to run. Getting that extra yardage. Barry Sanders, such a powerful runner. I've heard in the past Barry Sanders enjoys lifting with the linemen. He likes getting in there in the weight room. He likes to sweat and work and grunt with those big guys.
And they love him. First and 10. Derek Moore, the ball carrier, giving Sanders a bit of a blow. Derek Amazingly, Moore. Sanders was 8 for 20 in the first half, 8 carries for 20 yards. He's now got 12 for 67, and as we indicated, he can make him up in a hurry.
He certainly can, James. That's the thing about Barry Sanders, lightning strike. At any point, anywhere on the football field, he can hurt you.
Derek Moore still in at the back. Second and 5. Ball at the 20 of New England. 7:05 left in the third. This is Moore. And Moore, nice run by Moore for the first down. So Derek Moore out of Northeast Oklahoma giving Barry Sanders a break. Jack Lynn, nice block on the left side of that line.
A lot of ceiling here by the tight ends for Detroit. This is Dan Henning's type of football. They like to use the tight end. Tight end's very involved in blocking. At that point, he was actually coming from H-back position. They like to seal off that defensive end, pop the football right up the middle. Good run by Moore.
Excellent job in relief by Derek Moore. Barry Sanders back in, first and 10. Sanders down to the 5. 6:13 left in the third. Lions trailing 9-7. And Barry Sanders, and again, to underscore the point you made earlier in the game.
Yes, that point is Barry.
score a rushing touchdown for the Detroit Lions since 1989.
Folks, I tell you, this guy is the real deal, Barry Sanders, not only on the field, but off the field. Second and four. Sanders, the ball carrier, slicing and moving his way down to about the two. And if he gets down to the one, the Lions will have a first down.
James, it would be interesting to see if Chris Spielman checks into the game.
Mm-hmm.
As we know,
last week.
Mm-hmm. That's right. As we know, they brought Chris Spielman in to block. And here goes Spielman right now coming onto the football field. It would not surprise me in the least if Wayne Fonts gave the football to Chris Spielman.
Well, Chris Spielman has certainly suggested that to him. Chris Spielman in as the fullback. And it's third and one. Sanders. Loss of three on the play. Rod Smith in on the tackle.
Barry Sanders denied at the goal line.
Hansen on for the field goal. Attempt of 22 yards. Lions looking to regain the lead. The snap, the hold. And it's good, so the Lions regain the lead with 4:11 left in the third. Detroit on top, 10-9 over New England. 9 ball game right now, Lions on top, and the Patriots in a similar position last week against the Bills. What's important for them to keep in mind?
What's important for the Patriots to do now, going into the fourth quarter, don't have the breakdowns that cost them the football game last week against the Buffalo Bills.
Right now, are you seeing more consistent play as if they're focused a little better than last week?
Well, what we're seeing now, going into the fourth quarter, they were doing very well. They were playing very consistent Bill Parcells type of football. Mistake-free, fourth quarter, things just fell apart. It's going to be something to see Bill Parcells, what he's going to say to this team going into the fourth quarter.
Here in New England, and this game is presented by authority of the National Football League, and the CBS telecast is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of CBS, the New England Patriots, and the National Football League is prohibited. Dennis, now oftentimes you may have heard announcers or fans say this is an ugly game thus far after the fireworks of the early part of the first quarter. From a player perspective, ugly to you?
Certainly not, James. From a player perspective, from a defensive standpoint, both teams, Patriots and the Lions, they're playing well defensively. It's a low score. I think defensively they've got to be pleased with the way things are going. I would think that the Lions would like to shut down Drew Bledsoe just a little bit more. Offensively, there's where our problems are.
Be interesting to see what Hank Bullen may have cooked up, and we're still expecting some kind of junk defense, if you will, to be thrown at the youngster, Drew Bledsoe. First and 10 for the Patriots, ball from their own 20. Bledsoe. Complete for the first down, a flag on the play as Vincent Brisby hauls it in. Brisby had only one catch last week, but folks are very high on this talent. A 25-yard pass play, and we'll see what the call is from Gary Lane and his crew. I trust that the official took his hat off to kind of mark a spot on the field as opposed to having it knocked off, but we'll see here.
It out for receiver, out of bounds, caught the ball, lost it down, second down, previous spot.
Mm-hmm. Very clear.
Brisby was obviously forced out of bounds, came back in, made the reception. To the young man, we've got to tell him, you can't do that.
Well, he's quick of foot and perhaps thought not many folks saw that. Except for the good eyes over on the sidelines.
I certainly missed it, James.
Ditto. 3:56 left in the third. Lions on top, 10-9. Detroit, the record of 1-0 as a result of the victory over Atlanta last week. On defense, Russell, the ball carrier. And Russell not able to get out of the grip and grasp of Dan Owens. A gain of two on the play. And watching tape, you were very impressed with the play of Dan Owens, who did have a couple of sacks. But again, he was doing some things technically that you were very pleased with.
I certainly was. Watching Dan Owens, he's the type of a ball player that is certainly physical enough to just bull rush a man, to just take a man back to the quarterback. What I really like about Dan is he mixes things up. He'll use a little bit of finesse and get back to the quarterback. An excellent pass rusher that the Lions are glad to have on the team.
Third and eight. Russell in motion. And Bledsoe throws it complete for the first down. I tell you what, these routes are being run a lot better with that first down marker in mind as Vincent Grisby pulls it in.
Grisby does a great job getting the inside move. This is very good for a young wide receiver to do. He goes up, gets the football, brings it back down. Nice move by the young wide receiver.
2:45 and counting. Left in the third quarter play. McMurtry to the near side. Throw set for the Patriots. First and 10 from the 33. Play action. Bledsoe. Scrambling. And wisely runs out of bounds. Well, I tell you what, chalk up one of the smart category.
Certainly so.
George Jamison chasing.
You'd hate to see Drew Bledsoe try and turn it upfield. Wouldn't be in his best interest.
Now, that's not one of his strengths.
No, that is certainly not one of his strengths. Interesting enough, Bledsoe can run a 4.7 40, so certainly out in the open field, he can run the football. However, given the opportunity to try and juke somebody, I certainly don't think that's one of his strengths.
Now, interestingly, as I look at where it's spotted, they credit that as a sack. So a loss of one, second and 11. Nice defensive play on the part of the Lions. Was that Kevin Scott? As Swilling was over there trying to haul in the ball that was tipped by Kevin Scott. Excellent play.
Watch Bruce Armstrong against Dan Owens. This is excellent finesse move that I was talking about by Dan Owens. Bruce Smith, just a little bit of, pardon me, Bruce Armstrong, with just a little bit of holding there on
a
Dan
little
Owens.
Bit. Come on, Dennis. That was a whole lot of holding.
Who's playing defense, huh?
Third and 11. Ball at the 33, 1:59 left in the third. And Bledsoe tosses it to Coates. And Coates is going to be about 4.5 yards short of the first down marker there. So it will be fourth down for the Patriots, and Mike Saxon comes on to punt it away. I guess we have heard all we need to hear about this guy here. We know what he can do. Mel Gray back for the Lions, standing at his own 14. Didn't get the quick hop that he was hoping the ball would take, so it takes a New England roll down to the 9-yard line with 1:13 left in the third. A 51-yard punt is what it winds up being. Detroit ball at its own 9.
One of the side judges had his bell rung here on the last play on this punt right here. He is part of the playing field, but it's in his best interest to get out of the way. Watch what happens.
Bang. So that's why he was without his hat when we saw him a little bit ago.
All in the day's work, James.
As it was duty pay included, I hope. First and 10 from the 9. Peete going up top looking for Perryman. Intercepted by Hurst. And Hurst returns it to the 29 of Detroit.
Take that pressure off Barry Sanders. But on this play, Maurice Hurst comes up with some fireworks of his own. Watch Maurice Hurst get in front of the football. That's just great defensive football. Now it's his turn to run with the ball. He's got to evade the tacklers now. Finally corralled. Good job, Maurice.
First interception of the season for Hurst.
possession with 101 left in the third. Ball at the 29 of Detroit. Russell, the back, and the ball carrier. And Russell, the train, building up speed. 5 yards gained on the play will bring up a second and five.
Interesting enough from Bill Parcells' coach team, not making mistakes. Last week, the fourth quarter, they had a poor showing. This week, things look a little bit different, James.
Well, you know, Bill also mentioned how he really does have to temper his personality a bit. He is known to be abrasive in getting his points across, but he doesn't want to hurt the psyche of these guys. So he says, sometimes I have to go back and apply a tourniquet. And Russell, right now, applying the damage on the run, a four-yard run. Bring up a third and one for the Patriots.
No tourniquet needed yet.
Not yet. As we head toward the end of the third quarter play. So that's the end of the third quarter with the score. The Lions leading 10-9. Our coverage will continue after this message from your local station. You're watching the NFL. Defense Ball Club leading by one had a much better third quarter statistically.
Yeah, the Detroit Lions did play a little bit better there in the third quarter. I think they kind of settled things down, slowed down a little bit, start playing the type of football they wanted to. However, the costly mistake of Rodney Peete throwing the interception. Can't have that stuff. We don't want, Wayne Fonts doesn't want to see his ball club fall apart in the fourth quarter like Bill Parcells' New England Patriots club did last week.
So a couple things to watch then. The Patriots, who again fell apart in the fourth quarter against the Buffalo Bills after hanging close. We'll find out what happens here. And the Lions, looking to do better on the road, will have to do better on the road. Brandon Moore, tackle, elder receiver in for the Patriots. On the ground, though, and New England picks up the first down. That's a confidence builder.
That's definitely a confidence builder. Leonard Russell once again shows that power, that leg drive that he had. Up and over, gets the first down and more.
You see his numbers on the afternoon. And here's a guy who all New Englanders know back in late May was stabbed.
Once again, quite a recovery himself.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, the blade was only a few inches from the heart, but he has worked hard to recover and doing well. Obviously, first and 10. Patriots go back to Russell. A gain of about two on the play. And again, I was impressed in looking at Russell Guy from South Central Los Angeles, and we talked about the incident that he was involved in where he got into a little altercation with someone not of his own doing, provoked and stabbed. And again, that blade a few inches from the heart. But he says, hey, yeah, I've had some problems with fumbling, but believe me, I've gone through worse, and I'll correct that.
The fumbling issue is something that Leonard Russell put an end to very quickly. Says something he's not worried about, he's got to take care of it. So far, he's proven himself right.
Pat Swilling was coming after Bledsoe, who gets rid of it and throws it complete. And a gain of four on the play. That pass to Marv Cook, and it looked like Pat Swilling might have gotten the sack.
Here comes Marv Cook. Bill Parcells wants to use him. Nice. Releases him, takes the pass. That's a very safe route for Marv Cook to run. What he does, passes Swilling onto the quarterback. The quarterback knows very well that Swilling's going to come free, and he just dumps the ball off to Marv Cook. Good poise by the rookie quarterback. Great catch by Marv Cook.
Third and four from the 10 of the Lions. Russell. Looks like it may be a no gainer. We'll see where the ball is spotted. Final quarter of play, the Patriots looking for its first win of the season, having lost last week 38-14 to the Buffalo Bills. As Scott Sisson comes on to attempt the field goal to see if the Patriots can regain the lead.
Scott Sisson to attempt a 28-yard field goal.
So Sisson misses a 27-yard field goal, which should have been a chip shot.
Very costly.
Patriots, no doubt about it.
Very costly. Once again, fourth quarter blues.
Take
take a look at numbers, Bledsoe 17 of 32, only one interception. Detroit, though, has done a much better job, as I mentioned, in the third quarter. Sisson missing an opportunity to give the Patriots the lead again. And the score right now, Lions 10, Patriots 9, as you take a look at Sisson. And, boy, I tell you, those little chippies like that, you cannot afford to miss those.
That chip shot there is something that might come back to haunt Sisson and the New England Patriots. Once again, that's something you can't afford mistakes like that in the fourth quarter. That's a chip shot. It's something you've got to make.
First and 10, Detroit from its own 20, 12-16 left in the ball game. Incomplete pass intended for Barry Sanders as the Lions nurse a one-point lead.
Coming into the fourth quarter, James, Detroit 23-22 in possession time. New England 24-12, running neck and neck right in there. Total yards, Detroit with 199 total yards. New England 191. This has been a very even offensive football game so far this time.
Mm-hmm.
I would think that Bill Parcells wants to chew up the clock in this fourth quarter. They have got to score. They need that field goal back. They need to get 7 points on the board.
And the Lions lead the first down, second and 10. This is Sanders trying to give it to him. And he does, and a lot more. Barry Sanders, flag on a play, late hit as Sanders was out of bounds and getting hit. You know, when I asked Barry, and that was a 15-yard pickup, I asked him, what one thing have you learned most? Go ahead and get this first.
Barry Sanders dipping the ball to the outside. Watch the explosion right there. Very quick feet. Boom, he gets to the outside. Singleton here with a little bit late hit. There's the shot. Boom. That's going to cost him.
Singleton was involved with it, but they also give it to Harlan Barnett.
Right. That, James Brown, is a 30-yard play. 15 yards on the gain, 15 yards on the penalty. New England cannot get into this football game. I can't emphasize enough to you, New England is going to begin making mistakes.
Excellent point. Ball at the 49 of Detroit. This is Sanders, and Sanders, boy, what a weapon to have. Sanders takes it inside the 45 of New England. And again, getting back to that question to Barry Sanders about what has he learned since he's come in the league, he says, the one thing I learned came from the guy they call the wise old godfather, Mr. Ball, Jerry Ball, and that is when you're down, stay down.
That's right. When you're down, stay down. I'll tell you something interesting enough about Barry Sanders, how everybody's so high on this young man. Such a good football player, so humble. Something that doesn't show in Barry when he's on the football field, because he's all business.
Back to business for Sanders again as he tries to turn the corner and runs out of bounds about a yard shy of the first down marker. 1 yard gained on the play. Sanders just shy of the 100-yard mark for the afternoon. Since 1989, this guy has done it all on the field. So you can talk about the contracts of Thurman Thomas and what Emmitt Smith was trying to get. Sanders has delivered year after year.
Barry Sanders wants to play football, James.
Third and one. Sanders has it. First down for the Lions. Dennis, one of the things that you've done a lot of since you've come here, you've actually tried to keep things low-key, but you've talked to a number of kids who are going through some difficult times trying to recover from accidents and injuries, and you certainly want to send out a hello to a young man in Detroit who got inspiration from you as well.
Young Kimone Robinson, sophomore football player from Detroit Southeastern High School, he suffered a neck injury last week in practice, James. He's in the hospital there in Detroit at St. John's Hospital. Kimone, we want to tell you, just keep your spirits, young man, and just keep it up, pal.
No doubt about it. And Dennis is certainly proof that it can be done, young Kimone, and doing it on the field still is Barry Sanders as he picks up 8 yards on the play. He is over 100 yards for the afternoon, and that after going the first quarter, 5 carries for 6 yards, he's now got 24-105. Barry Sanders doing the job, 9:40 left in the ball game. Lions holding to a one-point lead as Derek Moore comes on to replace Barry Sanders.
Barry Sanders would have to be categorized as a very patient type of running back, James. He'll carry the ball 2, 3, 5 yards, then bang. He knows he's going to get the big play.
Second second and two. Peete complete to Moore for the first down. And Herman Moore gang tackled inside the 25. You know, I mentioned the expression confidence boosting on a number of plays for the Patriots. This has got to be confidence boosting for the Lions, controlling the ball, moving the ball.
It's very important for the Lions to do that at this point in the football game, James. Be mistake-free, move the ball very methodically down the football field. They're already up by one point. What they need to do, they need to get 3 points or a touchdown here.
Interestingly, controlling the football, something and one of the reasons they got away from the silver stretch of a couple years ago. First and 10, Moore running hard to the left. A gain of three by Derek Moore, the young man out of Northeast Oklahoma, giving Barry Sanders a breather.
It's imperative that the Lions score some points down here. A field goal makes it a four-point game. That means that New England has to drive the length of the field. They need to score. They need to get a touchdown. The Lions at this point can start to extend that stretch. They can start to extend that lead. If they get some points here, it's going to make it very difficult on the young quarterback, Drew Bledsoe, to come from behind. You don't want to put Bledsoe in a position where he's got to have a scoring blitz in the fourth quarter.
Second and eight, Sanders. Let's watch this one from the end zone. Sanders. First down.
Wow.
Boy,
wow.
I tell you, no matter what angle you look at Barry Sanders from, he's awesome.
Isn't that great? Barry Sanders running. No, I don't like that hole. He gets out. No, I don't like that hole either. And he just cuts it up. Here he goes. Barry Sanders takes standoff. Looks, no, not there. No, not there either. I think I'll go out here. No, I don't like that either. Let me cut back inside. Look at that. Isn't that fantastic?
Unbelievable. 117 yards on the afternoon for young Mr. Sanders, and he is still young. Very impressive stat there. From the 12 of New England, first and 10. 7-10 left in the ballgame. Sanders.
Oh,
he ran into Mr. Tippett. Mr. Washington.
Washington and Tippett telling Barry Sanders, we will have none of that. Taking a different view of the play. Barry Sanders just gets swarmed Andre Tippett.
Tippett's been hit harder than that in the dojo. Second and 13, ball at the 15, 6:35 left, Lions on top, 10-9. Peete, complete to Holman, and Holman inside the 10 to about the 9. The Lions need to get to the 2-yard line for a first down.
Well, James, if I got hit in my dojo, I'd probably fall to the ground myself. What's a dojo?
If you will, a gym where the martial artists work out.
Oh, I got it.
Spar, go through their katas and the like, break a few boards.
Andre Tippett, obviously into the martial arts. Tippett, he gets right in Pete's face. Peete can't get the receiver he wants. Bang, look at that shot. He's totally extended, laid Rodney Peete out.
Now, being very candid, you and I were asking the questions of each other. Hey, what happened to Tippett last week? What, one tackle, that was an essential tackle to that? And he even said he thought he lost a step, but he's playing a whale of a ball game here. Hey, Jason Hansen on for a 27-yard field goal. Jason Hansen increases the Lions' lead 13-9 with 5:40 left in the game.
Coverage of the National Football League is sponsored by O'Doul's from Anheuser-Busch, premium beer taste without the alcohol. The American Express card, don't leave home without it. Kodak Gold Film, why trust your moments to anything less? And by the Principal Financial Group, the financial company that gives you an edge.
Underway here in the fourth quarter play, 5:38 left in the ball game. Troy Brown 15, so the Patriots will start off with not the best of the field position, trailing 13-9. Sicker repeats, well, so are we. You have to go to prison. You don't want to go where Mike Wallace went. That brand new story tonight on 60 Minutes. That'll be followed, of course, by Murder, She Wrote, the season premiere. And then it's the CBS Sunday movie, Sherlock Holmes Returns. All that will be coming up tonight right here on CBS. The ball spotted at the 15. First and 10 for the Patriots, trailing 13-9 to the Lions. And a miscue. And boy, shades of the fourth quarter again against the Bills. We talked about that, and again, we cannot overemphasize how Bill Parcells was trying to drive that point home.
Bill Parcells getting that across to this young team. You can't do this stuff in the fourth quarter. These are the same kind of things that they were having trouble with last week in Buffalo. Fumbled snaps, interceptions. You can't do these kind of mistakes. Bill Parcells has got to be very disappointed so far with the fourth quarter.
He says coaches will be responsible for the strategy, but we don't make the mistakes or draw the penalties. And stripped loose. Excellent hustle defensively by the Lions. And the Lions recover, so it'll not only be credited as a sack, but the fumble recovery as well. Mark Spindler comes up with the ball, and you saw that reaction by Bill Parcells.
Pat's willing, coming off the corner against Bruce Armstrong. He just gets him on the speed rush. Wonderful, wonderful job just swatting the football out of his hand. That's excellent awareness by Pat Swilling. Pat Swilling, a veteran player, knows that he needs to get that football out, needs to get a turnover, switch that momentum, get the momentum on the Lions bench.
Leading by example, does not have a sack, but hey, he's doing a lot of other things today. So Chris Spielman reports as an eligible receiver, and I tell you, when he knocked that ball loose, he should be credited for a sack. We'll find out if they give him the sack. And Sanders dropped in the backfield. A loss of one on the play. Chris Billman and Adrian White writhing in pain on the field as he's holding that right wrist of his.
Chris Billman just loves to block. At this point, he gives a shot to 38 White. Comes here, Chris says he just likes to hit somebody. He's taking care of his job.
Nice. Oh, that was Spielman.
That was
Spielman. Did the job on that wrist. You know, and certainly all the Lions fans know that Spielman played running back, fullback in high school, so not an unfamiliar position for him. But this guy, Spielman, can hit, and there is living proof. Not good proof, but boy.
Look at this. Whenever Chris Spielman hits something, it's going down or it's getting hurt.
Mm-hmm.
In my opinion, this is a mismatch. White coming up to take on Spielman. Spielman, over 240 pounds. That's a train.
Well, remember last week it was Jesse Tuggle of the Falcons who got very upset and wanted to engage in fisticuffs because Spielman hit him so hard. But I mean, my gosh, who hit me? What hit me?
That's what a lot of people are thinking. I think that's what White is going through his head right now.
Mm-hmm.
Who in the world was that hit me?
And we did get an answer that, in fact, Pat Swilling was credited with the sack on that play. So Pat Swilling not only forcing the fumble, but coming up with the sack. Second and goal. Sanders. Flag on the play. And Sanders dropped at the 8. So a loss of 3 on the play, but there is a flag. Kevin Glover, the leader on that offensive line, a very quiet guy who can be vocal and one that the team certainly looks up to. Wayne Font said that Kevin Glover is coming off of simply an excellent preseason.
Kevin Glover, very unassuming, very quiet whenever you meet him, whenever you interview with him. But I assure you, after having played with him down in the trenches, whenever you're with him, he's anything but quiet.
Ball is marked at the eighth third and goal, but there's a timeout on the field called by Detroit, and Rodney Peete will head to the sidelines to talk this one over with Dan Henning and company. Coming up next week here on CBS as the NFL continues, we'll show you some games. Detroit will be playing at New Orleans, Washington at Philadelphia, the Rams will be at the Giants, and then at 4 o'clock it'll be the Falcons playing out of San Francisco, and we got a chance to see San Francisco in the preseason, and I tell you, that team just keeps on rolling.
They keep getting better too, James.
Third and goal. Peete. Stop at the 5. And Mr. Tippett leading the way.
Once again, a designed quarterback draw. Rodney Peete drops back looking for the opening. He would like to have taken it inside instead of going out, but he took what he had open. Patriots defense not being fooled. Nice form job by the Patriots.
Mr. Hansen on. This will be a 24-yarder. Lions will take it. Jason Hansen as he boots it through for a 16-9 lead. And Jason Hansen last week, the NFL Special Teams Award winner for Special Teamer of the Week. As I mentioned before, 7 kickoffs last week, all touchbacks, and good on 3 field goals. So this guy doing a nice job. Again, baseball coming your way here on CBS as we keep you on top of the pennant races. Awfully tight in the American League East. Baltimore a game and a half back. Yankees 1 game back of Toronto. And over in the National League West, well, we all know about that Atlanta-San Francisco battle. Atlanta now in first place by a game. And, of course, CBS will keep you on top of all the pennant races. Next week, it'll be the Red Sox against the Yankees, or some will see the Mets and the Braves. Coming your way Saturday at 2:30, and we are really blessed, Dennis, to have the lead production crew here, Bob Fishman and Bob Dekasaurus. Actually, he's changed his name.
Well, we won't say it. Anyway, back to live action here from the 3.
And excellent moves by Troy Brown as he takes it across the 20 to about the 23. And in keeping with that, we'll keep the baseball knowledgeable out there, updated with these scores as you take a look. Bob Dekus, of course, the name I was referring to. I think he now wants to be known as Mr. Roberto Dekus.
Little French accent.
That, of course, we were talking about the first Frenchman in 61 years who will be playing in the U.S. Open men's final. Coming up next on CBS, Sid Cedric Pioline.
Just jumping on the bandwagon there.
Mm-hmm. That's all he was doing. First and 10 for the Patriots. 3:15 left in the ball game. New England trailing 13-9. Bledsoe drills it complete. And it looks like Vincent Grisby fell for it for the first down. An 11-yard pass play. And Dennis, what would you expect to see in this series here by the Patriots as they try to get ahead?
Obviously, they've got to get the ball downfield, James. They've got to throw it, and the Detroit Lions know it.
Well, Bledsoe showing that he's very good at moving it forward. No fumble as Michael Thompson hauls it in.
The clock continues to tick down, James. That's something we're going to see, how Drew Bledsoe keeps his poise and uses the clock to his advantage
in this hurry-up offense. Second and 2, a gain of 8 on that play. Bledsoe looking for his third option and overthrows the intended receiver, Ben Coates. 2:17 left in the ball game. The Patriots with 3 timeouts remaining. Detroit with 2.
Drew Bledsoe, 19 completions and 35 attempts for 157 yards and that 1 interception. Of course, you know he'd like to have that back. However, that's not in his mind at this point. He wants to drive his football team down the field, score a touchdown, and win the ball game.
Well, they'll need to do that plus more. They're trailing 16-9. Obviously,
Obviously, a touchdown would even it up. They need a bit more. And complete for the first down. That one again to Michael Timpson. The clock still winding down toward that two-minute mark, 2:05. And we will hit the two-minute mark left in the ball game. Ball at midfield, and the Patriots trailing by a touchdown. The touchdown that came on the opening kickoff. Nine ball game right now. The Lions on top with 2 minutes. What would you expect to see defensively from Detroit against a rookie quarterback?
What you'd think with a rookie quarterback, James, is you'd like to have a defense that gives them a different look, something to try and confuse the young men. However, if you're the Lions' defensive coordinator, you don't want to put anything in that's going to cause your defensive players to bust the coverage and give Drew Bledsoe, the young quarterback, a cheap touchdown at this point in the game.
Bledsoe executing the hurry-up offense nicely right now. Good clock management as well. We'll see if Hank Bullock comes up with some junk defense. On first and 10, excellent hustle by the Lions defense. And George Jamison right on top of Kevin Turner. You see the clock still winding, and there's a loss of 6 on the play. Will bring up a second and 16. Ball marked at the 44 of New England. Bledsoe under pressure. Swinging just got there late. And a pass completed back up.
James,
did he hold on to it? I couldn't see.
I'm not sure if he did. The play there was a...
In fact, he did. Only 2 yards regained on the play. Makes it a third and 14, Dennis. Bledsoe. McMurtry. Now, if there's anything this hurry-up offense accentuates, it should be the arm of Bledsoe.
Certainly. Here goes the arm strength of Drew Bledsoe. That's what you love to have in these type of situations. Two-minute situation. Get that ball on that long, long pass, that out route on the far sidelines. That's where that strength of Drew Bledsoe really shines.
You see the timeouts remaining. 1:08 left in the ballgame. Patriots at the 38 of Detroit, trailing 16-9. Bledsoe going up top. No flag on the play. There it is, a late flag. Tim McGuire was defending Vincent Brisby. It was a similar kind of play last week where McGuire was beaten by Andre Rison of the Atlanta Falcons.
That's right. Tim McGuire got into a little bit of a bad situation there and got burned. This time, I think the contact is going to be called on the wide receiver. Offensive interference.
No infraction on the play. Ball was overthrown, could not be caught. Set it out.
So they're saying not catchable.
There you go. McGuire here on Brisby. Nicely thrown ball. It's out. Brisby just a little bit out of position. Looked like he tried to climb up on top of McGuire.
And McGuire wanted to make sure the official knew that as well.
That's right.
Second and 10. 1:01 left. Complete. What a hole in by Brisby. In the old days, they used to have stick-em on their hands. Boy, those are sticky fingers naturally.
Feel the excitement here, James. This is great. The crowd is just loving this. They love to see. They just love that competitive fire in Drew Bledsoe's eyes. Isolation on Brisby. Great catch. He goes up, brings it down.
And working on McGuire.
Working on McGuire.
But a good hustle on the part of McGuire, who seemingly got at least a piece of that ball and tried to dislodge it. But again, an excellent move and a good set of hands displayed by Vincent Brisby. So 54 seconds remain. Ball marked at the 25. Of Detroit, both teams with two timeouts remaining, and a touchdown is what's needed to tie it up. McGuire, a guy not lacking in confidence at all, but teams are working on him.
Certainly not lacking in confidence. Quite the contrary. Teams are working against him. I think they're working on that height advantage of Brisby at this point in the game. That's certainly something that's a plus whenever you've got to get those out routes. That's important.
And one other thing that you can be sure that Bill Parcells is aware of is that Tim McGuire still doesn't have his season legs yet, his game legs under him.
That's right.
First and 10, ball at the 25. two.
Good composure.
Incomplete. Intended receiver was McMurtry. The clock stops.
Pass incomplete intended for McMurtry.
26 seconds remaining.
McNeil and White on the coverage for the Lions.
Imagine that, James. This is an exciting football game.
I'd say so.
I would say so.
And still, the difference right now, that touchdown that Detroit scored on that fumble recovery of Willie Clay's 11 seconds into the ball game. Third and three from the 18, 26 seconds left. Working on Ryan McNeil.
Brisby getting to the outside. He wants to make this catch. He needs to make this catch. Goes up for the ball. That is just a wonderful effort, and he gets the call.
Ball marked at the three of the Lions. 22 seconds left. First and goal for the Patriots out of the pro set.
That electric defense of the Lions. I can't believe it.
Mark Spindler comes up with the loose ball.
Coming here off the right of your screen, Chris Spillman blitzing, getting to the young quarterback, Drew Bledsoe, knocking the ball out of his hands. Mark Spindler coming up with the fumble.
Defense.
Oh, there was a flag, a very late flag that was covered up, and it looks like the Patriots are going to get a reprieve.
Oh, how lucky. How lucky for the Patriots. Here's another angle. Coming from the top of your screen, Chris Spindler comes from the outside. Drew Bledsoe can't get out of his way. He can't dodge Spindler. Spielman, and Spindler comes up with the ball.
So wipe away the forced fumble and sack by Spielman and the fumble recovery. New England has it back. 16 seconds left. Ball on a two. It was a defensive holding call that gave it back to the Patriots. Bledsoe, all the time in the world. Point all too critical to tie it up, and we've got a dead even ball game with 12 seconds left in the game. We've seen it happen in 11 seconds.
Drew Bledsoe knows he's got to fire this football in there. He sets back, goes off his first read, finds Brisby. He sees him. Muscles that football in there. Brisby comes down with it. Watch Brisby at the bottom of your screen. Comes in, makes the inside move, gets in front of the defender. Drew Bledsoe threads it in there. Wonderful catch. From the end zone, view behind Drew Bledsoe. Looks off his first receiver, turns to the slant, muscles the ball. Watch Bill Parcells react. He's ecstatic. There's his young quarterback, the one that everybody's been worried about. Bill Parcells knew that he could do it. Drew Bledsoe drives the football club down the field, scores a tying touchdown. That is composure. That's poise. This young man is going to be a
good football plays.
The game clearly not over. Derek Moore and the dangerous Mel Gray back to receive. And George Jameson falls on it at the 35. 10 seconds remaining in regulation, and you see the timeouts remaining. Jason Hansen has kicked a 52-yarder. That's his longest ever. Detroit will certainly try to get him within range. Wayne Fonts has already shown confidence in him earlier, although he missed a 50-pluser, but he'll hopefully get his shot.
Tremendous leg on this young man, James Brown. You've got time to get in one play, get the kickoff.
From the 35, first and 10. Sanders running for the sidelines and runs out of bounds with 3 seconds remaining at the 43. That would be a 60, a 21-yard gain on the play. This would be some kind of kick. And I mentioned last week that Jason Hansen was extremely good with 7 touchbacks. 1 went through the uprights. The question here will, of course, be accuracy. And folks, as you take a look, trying to get some perspective on the screen here, you're looking at the distance, and as I mentioned, that's about a 61-yarder. And into the wind. Dennis, give us some idea of the distance that he's going to be kicking from.
I tell you what, James, the distance he's going to kick from, the ball is going to be snapped
at about the 44.
At about the 44-yard line.
Right here.
And here we go. Right here. Snap from here. James, look at this. You've got an airplane shot. You might as well be trying to go to Colorado. Heaven's sakes, look at that. Plus, James, not only does he have to get the ball there, he's got to get it between the uprights. Young man's capable of doing that.
And so Jason Hansen won't get an opportunity to attempt it as Wayne Fonts thinks twice about it. So Peete at the line of scrimmage. This is it. And no good. Intercepted by New England. So Wayne Fonts deciding to take his opportunities in overtime as Darrell Wren comes up with the interception. So we take it to OT with the ball game all tied at 16.
Getting the ball down the field. They're going for the Hail Mary here, folks. That is close. That is very close to watch that. Oh, heaven's sakes. New England's lucky they come down with that football right off the fingertips.
So we take in the coin toss here for overtime. Sudden death, overtime. And I know Jason Hansen probably wanted to give it an opportunity.
You get the feeling that Jason Hansen had the confidence to make that field.
Fields it is. You want the ball?
So New England is going to get the first opportunity to try and put this game away. We'll be back with the overtime action after this. Fans are getting their money's worth here. To take a look at the overtime rules, we already know New England has won the coin toss. 1 15-minute quarter. You see the timeouts per team, and as we mentioned, it is, in fact, sudden death. First team to score wins. And Dennis, again, you and I, quite candidly, were discussing during the break here, why wouldn't Wayne Fonts go for it? He's shown some risk-taking ability earlier. I mean, here, why not? I know 3 seconds left. Maybe is he thinking that maybe New England would have thrown the Hail Mary?
I'm not sure what he was thinking about. Obviously, Coach Fonts is a much better analyst of the situation than I would be from the field. Up here in the booth, I would have kicked the field goal. All you need is 1 point to win the football game. You would have got three.
And I guess as you run through the options, knowing it's a 61-yarder, you've got, you know, the possibility of it being blocked much greater as well.
That's right.
Lower trajectory, if you will. Well, Hansen wants to make certain that this one is not returned as Troy Brown downs it. Touchback. So it'll be first and 10 for the Patriots. Ball will be marked at their own 20. Wow, Philadelphia came back to beat Green Bay, and Phoenix finally knocks off the Redskins. Mark Griffin, we know, knocked out of that one. First win in Washington. Joe Bugle had never beaten Washington in Washington in his four, make that fifth year with the Cardinals.
Can Drew Bledsoe do it twice? This is the fifth quarter, something Coach Parcells hadn't had an opportunity to talk with him about yet.
Yeah, right, he talked about fourth quarter mistakes. And Spielman right on top of the play as he drags Big Ben Coach down. Spielman has played himself a whale of a ball game today.
Playing an excellent football game. As we'd mentioned at the top of the broadcast, Chris Spielman, a very astute football player. He considers himself a student of the game. They told us that nobody watches more film than Chris Spielman.
Mm-hmm. And Chris Spielman was talking about the 45 pages of notes that Hank Bullen, the defensive coordinator, had given him to digest last week.
A dizzying amount of material, James.
Second and 8. Ball marked at the 22. Bledsoe. Incomplete. Intended receiver, McMurtry. Taking a look at a couple of important numbers here. New England 5-11 in overtime games, and the Lions 5-7-1. You take a look at what was done by quarters. The Lions striking first, 11 seconds exactly into the ball game. Fumble by New England, picked up and run in by Willie Clay. 3rd and 8. Four wideouts out of the shotgun. Bledsoe calls it in, a high snap. Still looking, running, and he's going to be short. And the ball is loose, but New England picks it back up, and he's going to be short the necessary yardage for the first down. George Jamison, whom Wayne Fonts says is one of the most underrated linebackers in the game.
He's very high on him. He thinks that he has the speed, just the innate ability to get to the ball. He's always around the football. Wayne Fonts is very high on him.
Well, in talking with Fonts, he says one of the most important ingredients needed as you build a winning team is to have a number 23, Mel Gray, back to receive. Gray from his own 29. And Gray out of bounds at about the 42, looking for a late hit, but no call. No flag. 41-yard punt, 12-yard return by Mel Gray. And don't forget, coming up at the conclusion of this contest here, we'll bring you the U.S. Open men's final. That action between the 15th seed, Cedric Pialin, the Seed Slayer, if you will, taking on Pete Sampras. That'll be coming up next right here on CBS. So Detroit gets its opportunity. Sudden death overtime. Ball game deadlock, 16 apiece. James Brown along with Dennis Byrd. Up to about the 45, make it the 46. A gain of 5 will bring up a 2nd and 5.
Whose hand do you put the football in right now? James Brown, Barry Sanders, obviously. The man that Wayne Fonce is putting the eggs in the basket here. I would expect Barry Sanders, Herman Moore, to get the majority of the plays here in the fourth quarter.
And what do you think now in terms of Jason Hansen maybe trying to get the ball to where he's got less than 50 yards to boot it? Might be safe to think. Sanders. Maybe a yard. We'll see where it's spotted. 12:38 and counting down in overtime. 16-16 ball game. Andre Tippett on the stop. Tippett has played big today.
Tippett has played an excellent football game. He's certainly given that leadership to this defense that's played well today.
Third and four. Big afternoon for Sanders. Big play for Detroit. Complete to Sanders. No drop. Sanders had it momentarily and dropped it. And that was one of the areas that Wayne Fonce said Sanders had improved. And that was in his pass catching.
Here comes Rodney Peete. Drops back. Gets just a little bit of a roll to get away from that pass rush and get him closer to Barry Sanders. Throws the ball to Barry.
And Sanders, now Sanders had a look on his face like did not have it long enough and that the ground maybe forced it.
There's a bit of a question mark in Barry's mind. He thinks that he would have had that ball.
Not so. He doesn't get the ball. Arnold punting it away for the Lions. Troy Brown from his own 11. Across the 25. Dropped at about the 28-yard line. So Troy Brown gives the Patriots good field position. A 42-yard punt, 17-yard return. And don't forget, a full slate of games coming your way next week here on CBS. These same Lions will tackle the New Orleans Saints. Pat Swilling getting a chance to play against his old mates there. Washington at Philadelphia, Rams at the Giants. And at 4 o'clock, San Francisco will host the Atlanta Falcons. Boy, Jerry Glanville's got to be on the hot seat down there in Atlanta.
I would think so. Mm-hmm. The red gun offense, he's under the gun.
Not firing too well. So the Patriots get a second opportunity. 11:55 left in overtime. Patriots from their own 28, first and 10. Bledsoe going up top. Complete.
Is infectious. The rookie throwing to Leonard Russell. Leonard Russell just getting behind this man, got him by three steps, makes the catch and then runs with the football. Exciting. The crowd is ecstatic. They can't believe this. They're in a fifth quarter fighting against the Detroit Lions and doing a tremendous football job.
And at the 34-yard line of Detroit. On the ground, Russell stopped. Maybe no gain. So 28 of 47, 239 yards that last play, a 38-yarder to the versatile Leonard Russell.
Leonard Russell does a great job coming out of the backfield and making the catch.
And guess who may get an opportunity for New England? Scott Sisson. And his career longest, a 51-yarder. That in college. Second and 10. Bledsoe going up top. Incomplete. Grisby wanted pass interference.
The
but
official,
Kevin Scott was right there.
The official signaling that the ball was not catchable. Clearly, high and out of bounds, the official signaling there. Bledsoe, not too pleased about it. He thinks if he had had it just inside, it could have been a different story.
On third and 10, McMurtry to the near side. Out of the pro set. Ball marked at the 34 of Detroit on the ground. This is Russell. And Russell running. Inside the five, there's a flag back at the 37.
mistake, but guess what? Holding by the Patriots. Bill Parcells has got to be disappointed. Oh.
Holding offense, number 74, 10-yard penalty, repeat third down.
And that one is on the veteran Rich Baldinger and for the rookie Todd Rucci. Boy.
Right here, watch the holding here. Rich Baldinger. Oh, veteran ball player making a rookie mistake.
Mm-hmm. Hands outside the shoulders.
I don't know that I agree with that.
Oh, outside the shoulders like that? Incomplete. Going back to Brisby. And Bledsoe obviously showing he'd like to have that one back. 10-11 left in overtime. Sudden death overtime. All tied at 16 apiece. And Mike Saxon comes on having to punt it away. So Detroit will get another crack.
Mike Saxon to punt.
Mel Gray back at his own 10.
Always dangerous, James.
We'll see what the hang time is. That's crucial. Well, he figures, why mess around with the hang time?
Just
let him start it from their own 20. Keep it away from him.
Keep it away from Mel Gray. He does not want him to have the ball right now.
That's not a bad option.
No.
Smart option.
Good call.
So Wayne Fonts, you see Dan Henning to the left there, talking with Rodney Peete. Dan Henning, offensive coordinator, and Wayne Fonts went out of his way to say that Dan Henning has done a nice job with this offense, had to retool it to get them away from that silver stretch or run and shoot. Wow, all tied up in the fourth quarter. Atlanta, well, maybe the Red Gun is firing some serious bullets right now.
It looks like Glanville's the one shooting the gun right now.
Rodney Peete hoping to fire accurately here. First and 10 from his own 20. Taking care of the Phillies in the top of the eighth, 6-1. Philadelphia not helping itself at all. And I tell you what, if the Expos win this one here that's in the bottom of the sixth, they can close to within 5. Boy, things tighten up everywhere. Toronto trying to help itself, leading California by 3 runs in the top of the eighth. New York certainly not helping itself there, losing to Kansas City and only being 1 game in back of Toronto. Rodney Holman in motion. Peete escapes the pressure and gets it away to Sanders, and he's got a little room, has the first down, and turns the corner, run out of bounds at about the 36, 37-yard line.
Good awareness by Rodney Peete. He steps up, keeps his composure. He's under a lot of pressure, dumps the ball to the marquee player, Barry Sanders, and lets Barry go to work.
Mm-hmm.
Barry Sanders runs right into Coach Parcells, right here. Look out. Oh.
And that's from a linebacker. As a matter of fact, you surprised Bill Parcells with the performance that he allegedly turned in college.
I'll tell you about that in a minute, James. It's worth repeating.
No question about it. Lions will try to repeat what they just did here on first and 10. They get it to Derek Moore. And Moore upended. Nice tackle by Vincent Brown, taking Moore off of his feet.
Let's go back, James Brown, in 1963. The Wichita Shockers are playing the Tulsa Golden Hurricane,
mm-hmm.
my alma mater. There's a young defensive lineman for the Wichita Wheat Shockers, had 20 tackles and 6 quarterback sacks. That was Bill Parcells, James.
Mm-hmm. And he was actually kind of blushing when you recited the numbers that he turned in that game.
He said he didn't even think they kept sacks back then. Those were tackles for loss.
Probably didn't. Second and 7. Peete. Incomplete. Intended receiver was Herman Moore. And I guess Peete had a decision to make. He could have run for that one, but he decided to try and launch it.
Wren on that play coming up big. Once again, Wren, the third team ball player, coming in this situation and performing admirably. Good job. Rodney Peete, when given the option, would have rather gotten the ball to the wide receiver so he could take it and get out of bounds.
If you're just tuning
Watch Herman go up for this football. Look at that. Fantastic job by Herman Moore.
Knowing he was going to be taken out. Meaning the hit. His legs taken from up under him.
Takes a lot of courage to go up for balls like that. Something that I wouldn't like to do myself.
He's got a good basketball game. So that skill comes from that as well. First and 10. Ball at the 48 of New England. Sanders, the ball carrier. And ahead for maybe three. The Lions again trying to get within field goal range for Jason Hansen. And keep in mind, coming up after football, the U.S. Open men's final. Pete Sampras, the man who has the most complete game on the tennis circuit, taking on Cedric Pioline, the 15th seed. And it was an open of upsets. Pioline trying to knock off Sampras.
The Detroit offense, James slowly, inch by inch, working their way into field goal range.
Second and seven. From the 45 of New England. Play action. Peete complete to Perryman for the first down. Inside the 30 of New England. Big reception by Perryman. Excellent play by Rodney Peete.
James, I think it's safe to say that they're within field goal range now. It'd be interesting to see what kind of safe play calling they call. Great strike to Perryman.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if Wayne Fonts is going to be conservative, give the ball to Barry, get him within just a few more yards, give Hansen that extra bit of confidence.
From the 28, Sanders. And Sanders picks up maybe about four forward progress. Should reveal about a 4 yard gain on the play, as he gives Jason Hansen a few more yards of cushion. 30 carries, 144 yards on the afternoon for Barry Sanders. And he indicated to us it makes no difference the surface he runs on, grass or turf.
Barry Sanders can care less. And quite frankly, I don't think it matters if he's running in a sandbox. Barry Sanders is going to get those yards.
5:30 left in overtime. Most importantly, team that scores first wins. Ahead for about another four. You know, speaking of any surface, I saw Barry Sanders a couple seasons ago in Green Bay run on the frozen surface of Lambeau Field. Everyone else slipping and sliding but Barry Sanders.
Barry Sanders, wonderful feet. What can you say, James?
So the spot makes it a 3 yard gain. Ball at the 21. Third and two. Sanders again. No gain on that play. Chris Slade, who has had himself one fine defensive afternoon. So Hansen will come on. This should be about a 37 yarder. And at that range, he is perfect. 10 of 10. The man who was the special teamer of the week last week, the inaugural award in the NFL. But where it's spotted, this will be a 38-yarder for the ball game. And the Lions pull out the overtime victory on the strength of that 38-yarder by Jason Hansen to move to a record of 2-0 for the first time since 1985, as Bill Parcells and the New England Patriots fall to 0-2. Wayne Fonts, who recognized when we talked with him last night that his team was 1-4 on grass in the year of 1991 when they were 12-4, says we'll do it today, and they did.
Hansen, obviously elated, wins the football game for the Lions. That's the ball game, James. Great job by Bledsoe, the rookie, showing extremely good poise. Wonderful job. Posted some very impressive numbers. However, the mistakes that were made in the fourth quarter were just a bit too much for the Bledsoe to overcome.
And a solid afternoon by Barry Sanders. So for Dennis Byrd, I'm James Brown saying so long from Foxborough Stadium, where the final score of the Lions win it in overtime, 19-16.
coming up next. It's the U.S. Open men's final with Cedric Pioline matching up with Pete Sampras for the championship. You've been watching CBS Sports coverage of the National Football League.